I love how it just goes from like the little, like the retro music, or not retro, but I think it was like I had a, it's something I got, cause I fucked up all my shit. I like how I just also start talking, no halai, the halai? Oh, it's gonna be a night, no hello or anything, it's just like, yeah, fucked up all my shit, the music switch, boom, it's raining, it's here, it's happening. Power went out yesterday, ironically because of the rain. But we're back. Oh my god. I'm just getting finishing up my going live stuff for Okay, that's done. Let's go. Oh my god, bro. Alright, let's put this on the wireless charger, let the wings come out of the charger, there we go. It's all kicking off, it's all happening. So, I just want to make sure everything is going correctly. Can the game be heard? Please be the question. Because I don't think the game can be heard. I also did- oh my god, I'm really just- I'm going for it. Really just going for it. Don't mind me. Where's the game? Where's the game audio? Come on. Make it- oh, it's down there. I'm done. Oh, not that, not that. I still want my sound on this, even though they're not working, but okay. Not that they're not working, but, you know, that's really Twitch stuff. I haven't figured out how to, like, get sound looped on. But anyway, enough dilly-dallying, enough, twiddling my thumbs. Let's get into it. I shite my guides. I forgot to put a separate capture. Love the game. For a little old me. For myself. Yeah, there we go. Pop this bad boy out, do like that. We're here. You know what? This is such great stuff. It's so great. It's beautiful, some would say. It's me. I'm the some who would say. Trying to convince myself otherwise. There we go. Make it nice and pretty. Now I can see. Shiz. You know what? That works too. No, actually, no, we're not doing that. Stop. Ah! Anyway. Oh, God. Holy moly. And of course, there's somebody with my allies here. Honestly, Bow the crown. Unreal engines. The amount of scuff right now is unreal. This game is obviously a feature. Yes. Yes. Let us go. Let us do the rainbow. Press any button. Then we're going to do the start. Then we're going to go and do this. And we're going to go to... Yes. Alright, let's do this. Mansion. Mansion located in the high-class residential district on Montclair Street. Owns a mansion. Owner of the mansion made a sizable amount of money through real estate dealings. A man around the age of 30, an endless sea of rumors surrounds him. A work apron made by camera manufacturer White Cross. The pockets are durable enough to hold heavy objects without losing shape. Means of communication. Most communications to people outside Connor Ward are taped. Okay, alright. Taped. Hello, Halara. Okay. Alright, so I think, last time, like the badass they are.
It looks like a haunted mansion.
I mean, considering someone died here, it may be.
I hope there aren't any ghosts around. I have a feeling they'll appear this time.
Okay.
I've been meaning to ask, but aren't you kind of a ghost yourself?
Exactly, like, and here I go again, you know what, just put me in the gosh darn game. Just put me in the game at this point. If I'm gonna just keep predicting what...
The incident occurred about 3 months ago. The victim was Ali Hohen, the owner of this mansion.
And I will admit this, so... I love this game so much. But even still, I keep predicting what they're
gonna
say.
He had no family and lived alone. The mansion is now empty and dilapidated.
Dilapidated. That's a word.
The crime scene is in the study near the back. Let's go.
Alright, pushing onward. Just rip the tapes, big on, move.
The mailman killings had another common factor, besides the locked room.
Is it the strangulation?
The first person to find the body was always the same person.
Which is, that is true as well.
That worshiper from church? Do you suspect him too?
What he said did make sense. He's been obsessed with the nail man and had access to the names of potential victims.
But I feel like when you're like obsessed, like they've done it on like, the SVU, whatever, Law and Order, and they're like, oh man, I'm so obsessed with this serial killer and I'm investigating their series and oh my gosh, you know what, I could be him, it can be me. And it's just like, no. Why would you want that for yourself? But...
It's not too surprising for him to be the first on the scene each time.
I guess I shouldn't assume things going into this.
That's right.
Never assume anything, because when you assume, you make an ass out of you and me. Let's go.
It's down this hallway.
I forgot what
the crime scene is in the room on the right side. There's little time. Let's head straight there.
Think your partner's now? Just because you held hands with my master.
Describe Halara's voice. I just love the voice actors they cast for this game. I just love them all.
Master and I are connected on a much deeper level.
You know, well, I can't even be mad at the voice actor. It's just how the actor, the character acts. Like, I'm so disconnected from her, I can't even be bothered to remember her first or her last name. She is a mix of Sayaka and Sonya Nevermind. That's what she
is. Don't make it sound so suggestive.
Alright, let's do this.
Feels like a jump scare is coming up.
Bro, really? Okay. Alright, Shinigami, I see you.
So this is the study where the crime took place.
I wonder if that actually scared people.
Oh, it's open. I wonder if the lock was broken at the time of discovery here, too. There's nothing left here either. It's all cleaned up.
Now, wait a minute now. As an owner of fish, how are these fish alive if this place has been abandoned? You can't just tell me somebody, and it's supposed to be blocked off. And I know it ain't gonna be the peacekeepers in here taking care of these fish, so how are they alive?
I don't want to do it, but I suppose I can share my post-cognition again here.
Because sharing is caring, so, you know.
Are you sure?
But again, how are these fish alive? Like, how they ain't got fish rod, or fin rod, or just how are they all alive? Just moving.
Don't make a big deal out of it. Just make it quick.
Investigation time. Alright, let's see. Who do I want to split? Excuse me? Shinigami? Okay. We're gonna look at these fish. Because I want to know. Alright, fish tank.
That's true.
There are fish in a fish tank. No duh. Who is washing clothes? I swear, every time I stream, somebody is washing clothes. But it doesn't seem like they've been cared for since the owner was killed. They're looking pretty bad. They should be dead. Inside the tank, some kind of secret passage?
Yeah.
Would it be interesting? It doesn't appear to be related to the case. Okay. And I guess post-cognition, what are we looking at? Hand-holding!
The crime scene of the murder is vividly brought to life before us. It all happens in silence, as though awakening from an eternal slumber.
Okay.
But the corpse will never wake up again.
I would hope not. I mean, not saying that hope not.
If the corpse did awaken, the nails pinning him down would prevent him from rising. The door is the only entrance and exit to the room. Mm. There are no windows, and the vent is small. I don't see any escape routes from the locked room.
Okay.
Maybe the doll nailed to the wall holds the answer to this bizarre mystery.
Okay. Alright, alright, so fish tank is probably not even important. There's a switch. Let's see. There's a switch in the for the projector on the desk. Looks like it was set to off when the corpse was found. Okay, we have a lamp.
Oh!
The lamp's light is pointed at the table. It probably wasn't turned on at the time. I don't see anything suspicious. Doesn't seem like the lamp is related to the case. Okay. The projector. The projector is installed in the center of the bookcase. It wasn't on when the corpse was found. You'll never reach it, Master. I'll check it out. Check it out for you. I'm just gonna give her a Valley Girl voice at this point. Well, did you find anything unusual? Nope, everything is extremely usual, unrelated to the case. Alright, the fish tank. There's a huge tank here, but there aren't any fish inside. Living things can't be seen through post-cognition. It doesn't have them. Okay. Anything else? Everything else, I guess, is checked out. Alright, so we're gonna go out of that. Let's see. Check near
it
the hallway.
Yep, it's nothing.
Or we could check the door too. Can I? I can't.
Let's
DM.
Check
I can't.
Every
step. What do you mean check near the hallway? Bookshelf near the hallway. All these books are lined up so neatly. They're covered in dust. Nobody's touched them for a long time. Meaning, they won't help us with the case. Okay, well... Alright, well then what's up? Alright, we're gonna hold hands now. Okay. Ah, okay, doll on the wall. It looks less like the others.
There's only one doll nailed to the wall.
Like, cheaper.
Comparatively, there was a nearly obnoxious number of dolls nailed to the walls in the other crime scenes. Maybe there was no room to nail them to the walls, because of all the bookshelves in the way?
There's still plenty of wall space.
Wait, this doll has both eyes gouged out.
That's a little unsettling, okay.
Did the culprit do this on purpose?
Mayhaps.
This keeps getting more and more disturbing.
But it's kinda creepy cute. I want to put one next to the top of a staircase so people can run into it at night.
Wow, that's a little rude, don't you say? You just run up the staircase and it's like, ooh, the bitch.
Why would you want to do that?
Because
works.
You know, this doll seems made of cheaper materials compared to the other ones.
Hey, you're right. Like it's made of resin instead of porcelain.
Porcelain is like the... I know what resin is.
Sure looks cheap, but also more durable.
Too bad it doesn't have eyeballs.
The eye holes are connected to each other in the head cavity.
Okay.
It's like that darkness is staring.
Why you gotta zoom in on that? Actually, no. Yeah, no. I was thinking about just making a thumbnail of it, but I'm like, nah.
Huh? There's a mark on the edge of the eye holes near the nose.
Like something in a corner or something. Okay. So we got that checked out. Probably nothing near with the bookshelf, I don't think.
Yeah.
Even in the past, several books line the shelf. I checked, but it doesn't seem like anything's different between then and now.
I see.
In that case, it's probably not related to the case. Alright, so I guess, alright, we're gonna turn post cognition off, and we're gonna exit out of this. I like to try and save the body for last, just because. It's a check out my own painting. Your painting.
Oh!
Landscape paintings and extravagant frames are on display. All these paintings look incredibly expensive.
However,
they're counterfeits, not a single one is genuine. Doesn't look like there's anything relevant to the case here. Let's investigate elsewhere. Okay. And more bookshelf by the desk. Wait, then there's also... Okay, so we're gonna do this, stack books, and I think that's it for this area before post-cognition. It's a carefully organized bookshelf. Looks like all the novels belong to the same series, the Gawain Saga?
Yeah.
I believe this series has more than 150 volumes. Unfortunately, the author has passed away. It's a shame the story never saw an ending. Okay. And stack books.
Oh!
Two extraordinary thick books are stacked on the desk. These books are in great condition, aside from some dust. They look completely untouched.
It's me.
He probably wanted to seem knowledgeable. They haven't been moved for a while. They're probably not related to the case. Okay. Turn on post-cognition. Alright, so we got more dolls on the floor. Oh, doll near the floor. Check this doll. Why is it bald? Wait, you'll hear it! Several dolls have been nailed to the floor. After the clock tower and the secret club. This makes three. It doesn't make it any less creepy, though.
It's me.
Now's not the time to show fear. Investigate thoroughly and find the clues to solve this case. Right.
I see.
The dolls have nothing in common, and I don't see any unusual markings either.
It appears.
Nothing to do with the case, though. Okay. Painting.
What does that mean?
There's an expensive-looking landscape painting, but it's tilted. I wonder why. Could this be related to the locked room?
It appears.
Doubtful. Judging by the marks on the wall, I'd say this painting was hung in an igloo. The peacekeepers must have altered it by mistake during their investigation. How confusing. Stack books?
Hmm?
Two extraordinarily thick books are placed on the desk. It doesn't look like the books are stacked when the body was found.
Well,
the peacekeepers must have stacked them. Good grief, what a bunch of amateurs. The placement seems to be the only thing that's changed. I don't think this will help with the case. Okay, I'm gonna go bookshelf by desk. A series of books is arranged neatly on the shelf. There's no indication the books have been moved. I don't think they're related to the case. I agree. Let's look somewhere else. Okay. So turn post-cognition off and leave this area. I think what's left is the body and the door. So we're gonna look at the door. And like I said, I always save the body for last. Alright. We got a vent and a door.
There is a vent, but it's too small for a person to fit through.
I also love how, like, the hood is that. So, you know how, like, in cartoons and stuff and other games, the characters will have a hood, but it, in no way, shape, or form does it look like it'll ever fit on their head? At least in this game, it looks like it'll actually, like, it's an actual functioning hood. And it's small stuff like that that just makes me happy for some reason, because I'm a weirdo. But anyway.
And it's also screwed shut from the inside. It seems impossible to remove.
What's this now? Master, I discovered something. There are marks in the gap between the fence, like something scraped against it.
See, he's short, so he wouldn't be able to see that.
Really?
But given your height, you couldn't see it even if you stood on a chair.
Alright, well...
Halara, can you use that chair to peek into the vent?
I will do so for 10,000 Xian.
Bro, why are you charging me just to stay here, please? I'm already broken up as it is.
You're charging me for it?
I jest.
Okay, that's... That's cute. That's... But I have been jesting. Okay.
The marks in the vent seem to be left by strings rubbing against it.
Why they got some strings that be leaving all these marks? Like, what strings y'all buying that be doing all this?
Did someone hitch a string to it or something? It shouldn't even be visible from your perspective.
Don't worry about it.
I'm surprised you noticed.
Don't worry about it. I'm skilled like that.
It was just a hunch.
See? I told you I'm useful. I do way more than just float around. You should give me 10,000 Xian as a reward.
No.
Are you kidding? A headache.
For me, it's the way he uses certain lines for me that just get me. That's just like... Man's just done. He's just shut up. He's just like, man. Alright, so the vent's too small for a person to exit or enter the room. Or enter the, or exit the, exit from, Jesus. There's evidence that a string or something similar scraped against the gap in it. Okay, so we have that, and then we're gonna do the door.
This is...
The door to the study. We left it open just in case.
Hmm.
It's always good to be wary of sudden attacks. Never let your guard down. Right, got it.
I'll.
It's because of the teaching of your truly. You're welcome, Master. Okay, alright. Post-con mission, let's go. The door.
The door here can only be locked with a key. However, there is only the master key. No spares exist. The scenario resembles the locked room mystery in the casino. We can disregard the possibility of a duplicate key.
Okay.
The master key was found in this room at the time of discovery.
This is also similar to the locked room mystery in the secret club.
But there is one difference. The key was found underneath the corpse.
How the freak frack tic tac did you do that? Wait.
Under the corpse? But we can't move the corpse in the past, so we can't confirm if that's true.
Postcognition isn't all powerful, but it's a fact that the key was found under the corpse.
Okay.
I have a crime scene photo.
Bro, if Laura's just like, source, just trust me, bro. Just trust me.
No detail has slipped past my efforts.
Laura really do be thorough, though. Like, they're very dependable.
Right.
I know, I think last stream I was like wavering. I'm like, I don't know if Halara is like moving off of my favorite like character list or likable character list, but they're keeping steady ground. I can't be mad at them. Okay. So what's this?
Huh? What's this?
Wait! Halara, explain. Halara.
Wait, not that one. I meant the other photo. This one is unrelated to the case.
That's a blistered Halara. Oh, that's cute.
Oh, this is it.
Oh, you're that's right. Cute. I like
the
that.
The key's
that
in
was...
the middle of his back. But can this photo be trusted? Could it be something that peacekeepers fabricated?
Why would they feel the need to fabricate that, though? Like, they already don't want to do their job enough as it is. Why would they? I don't know.
The peacekeepers acknowledged the incident occurred in a locked room. Besides, there's no need for fabrication.
Exactly.
After all, it would be more convenient for them to have fewer mysteries to deal with.
Exactly. See, all right, Halara, you're moving back up there. I love me a logical character. Let's go.
That's true. Sorry for being doubtful.
No, that's expected of a detective.
Look at Halara's
starting to figure out how to do your job.
Well, she's being a even in the game, it's like, alright, I feel like it's another, like, kind of a Chihiro situation, where it's like, alright, don't know your gender or what you want to go by, so I've just been using they, them, because, I don't know.
Was that a compliment?
Oh, look at the little blushy.
That's really all it takes to please you?
Oh, shut the hell of your mouth when you got me.
Also, I drew a sketch of the room's state on the back of that photo.
Okay.
Remember it well.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Why a sketch? How could it help also?
Also?
What was with that cat photo anyway?
Don't worry about it.
It's surprisingly cute.
Don't worry about it. The key to the mansion study. There are no copies of this master key. The mansion's floor plan and a photo of a lock of the lock and mystery, both received from Halara. I feel like Halara is such a pretty name too. Like, if I had a kid, maybe I would name them Halara. That'd be a good name, I think. I don't know. Alright, let's see. So yeah, door, the last thing we need to check is the Balte. Okay. Alright, so okay, there's the thing.
That's true.
This is where the first witness found the body. The bloodstains are still here. Considering the amount of blood, the victim was probably killed here, right?
It appears.
It seems very likely. Okay. Post confirmation, let's do it. Alright, so victim's neck.
The cause of death here appears to be strangulation as well.
Alright, so yeah, that's a reoccurring thing, it seems like.
And like the others, there are rope marks around the neck and traces of a struggle.
Okay.
Oh! But on a closer look, there's a mark left by a thin string on the back of his neck.
Double string? What are we doing?
It couldn't have been the rope that was used to strangle him. The thickness is completely different.
Way off.
There are two different types of string marks on the body. Was he strangled twice?
That seems unnecessary.
But even then, it'd be odd to only have marks behind his neck.
Yeah, not around.
And why do the strings have different thicknesses?
Anyway, it's an important piece of evidence.
It is indeed, so we'll take that to note, I guess. Okay, the rope marks caused by strangulation and wounds from resisting. There's also string marks on the back of the victim's neck. Okay, so we have that mystery for you. We'll look at the corpse itself.
The victim is a well-built man, approximately 30 years old.
Okay, that hairdo, though.
The corpse here is also covered in nails.
What? Oh, what was that?
His appendages and chest are all nailed to
that show. Good Luck Charlie, and then there was the little boy Gabe. I think he had a haircut like that at some point too. Like, what is that? Why do you gotta walk around with a whole freaking triangular cone on your head? Like, what? I never understood that. Out here having hair defying gravity and such. But whatever. Okay.
The owner of this mansion made his fortune in real estate from an early age.
Props to him.
But along with aggressive land sharking and other illicit transactions.
Okay, never mind.
He made shady deals with Amaterasu Corp.
That's essentially all the people that died were, I guess, because of how the mailman works, I guess somebody wanted them gone, which is like, damn, alright. But, you know. Not saying
there
he deserved
are
it.
Several
but.
Reasons he'd be hated. A doll with his name on it was bound to be nailed in the church forest.
I wonder how the person who cursed him feels now that he's actually dead.
Who knows?
Perhaps they feel no responsibility. They just hopped on the urban legend bandwagon.
Is that really the case?
Could be.
Wait, this is odd.
Okay. What's up?
Did you find something?
What?
Look closely. The length of the nails driven into the corpse. All slightly different.
Maybe. No, I was gonna say something like dumb, like, oh, maybe. I don't know. Yeah, no, I couldn't even think of what I was gonna try and say. But that is true. True. The blood is also different. As well.
The length isn't the problem here, it's how hard they were hammered in.
Like, maybe they just lost strength. Maybe they just got tired, you know?
What do you mean?
The nails driven into the lower torso went through the body and into the floor. Mm. But the nails in the upper torso did not penetrate all the way through the body.
That's they probably just got lazy. Let's just say that.
But why would the culprit not hammer the nails in as hard on the upper body?
That's not the only unnatural thing. Take a look at the blood.
Look at me being perceptive.
The nail wounds on the lower torso appear to be bleeding sideways. But the upper torso wounds are bleeding vertically.
Yeah, which is waist. Weird.
The blood flows differently between the upper and lower body?
Maybe the upper and lower torsos are different people?
No.
And they were smushed together after death.
No, no, honey, no. That's not how that works.
Disturbing.
Alright, so is there anything else? I don't think there's anything else.
Looks like there's nothing left to check.
Yay, that's an A-okay for the investigation here. Alright, let's end it. Finished. Alright, so I think there's two more crime scenes we have to look at, I believe.
Now we've gathered enough evidence. Though it appears complicated at first glance.
What is that?
Hilara, did you already solve the locked room mystery?
Yuma, just play along, because then it's going to be known that you're dumb.
What? You haven't?
Oh, shit. Not the condescending, get good. Just skill issues,
There's no way to solve it with what we have. How was the room locked?
It's unfit for one detective to ask another that question. For the sake of your own pride. You must figure it out.
Look at Hilara looking out for our pride and stuff, though.
Unless you'd like to hire me to do it for you. It won't come cheap.
Alright, so Hilara got jokes, I guess. Hilara just likes to... Hilara got jokes, that's all I'm gonna say. Just looking at their face.
I'll figure it out myself.
You wanna hire me, you broke bitch? You owe me money?
It's really all about the money with Hilara.
Not the Hilara.
The longer I'm with Hilara, the deeper into debt I'll get. It's starting to scare me.
Now, let us be swift. Next up is our last crime scene.
Oh, I thought there were...
Wait!
No, because we already did the clock tower, then we did the club, and then we did this, and then it should be... Oh, what was the last murder case at? I think it was the art museum, if I remember correctly. Wait a minute. Oh, okay, I'm about to say, why is there a question mark in the house? There should be nobody in here, but...
The next one is the art gallery in Gima District.
Gima.
We're running low on time, so we must hurry.
Okay.
Right. The chief's in danger, after all.
He's in danger. We gotta save the scruffy man. Alright, so it's also in Gima District, which luckily we are in Gima District right now. Flippin' flapjack mamma. Anyway, screw the peacekeepers. I'm a menace. I shall disturb all of the peace. Art gallery. There were many visitors prior to the exhibition of Kanai Ward, but current attendance is not stellar. Nailman, the culprit behind the serial murders occurring in Kanai Ward. The Nailman's crime scenes are always locked rooms filled with pain. Dragon Place, a popular meat bun shop in Gima District. They sell at the higher than usual price of 500 chien a piece, but the owner insists it's due to something. I need to finish reading. Alright, excuse me, pardon me, with your fancy drone umbrella. Ooh. Okay. What? Nope, I need to stay focused instead of trying to wander around. And wander around on my own time to investigate things. Okay, let's see. I'm guessing this is the art museum. Actually, wait a minute. Did I ever? Oh my god, there's so much stuff that I just not haven't. Wait, I have a quest too. Oh, okay, no, that's already so. Okay. What is it? Abilities, yeah. Status. I need to up my skills. Yeah, because I have not messed with any of this. Do that. Yes, equip. Let's see. Shinigami puzzle sequence is remove one solution key. Shinigami will barf up. Yeah, let's do that. Yes. No, let's see if we can do the upgrade version. Solution key sequence is remove one incorrect solution key. Number selectable solution keys cannot be one or a little. What's this? And reasoning deathmatch sequences shorten the assist ability's recovery time. I'm really not worried about that. But it'll unlock something for me, so we're gonna do that. We're not gonna equip it though. Let's see. Repel revelation and reasoning deathmatch sequences reduce the number of colored words and the mystery phantom statements, make it easier to identify what to repel. We'll unlock this. Unlock more stamina. We're going to equip. We're going to unequip that. I'm gonna do this. Yes. No, not yet. Shinigami puzzle sequences remove two solution keys. Shinigami will barf up. Ooh, let's get that. And we're gonna equip that. Increase stamina by 200. When combined with Stand By Me in reasoning deathmatch sequences, the assist ability recovers faster. If equipped alone, the same effect as Stand By Me 1. Okay. I'm gonna unlock this for right now. See what this leads to. Okay, this is another. I'm going to equip that. And what does this do? Reasoning deathmatch sequences remove one incorrect solution key. Okay. I don't have enough SP to unlock that. It's gonna take 3 to unlock that. We're gonna unlock more stamina. That's what we're gonna do. Because you can never have enough stamina. We're gonna equip that. We're going to unequip that. Because I don't think it helps me. Or I don't think it, like, doubles over. If that makes sense of what I'm thinking. Let's just unlock this as well. We're gonna unlock that. And we're not going to equip it though. And Shinigami puzzle break two incorrect letters. Okay, so I have to save up for that possibly. You know, we're going to equip this. That's equipped. What, I wonder what happens. So we're gonna do like that, right? We're gonna do status. My stamina is okay, 1,200. If we go here, what if I do that? Equip that. So status. Oh, so it does carry over. Hey yo. Okay, so we got that going. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead head up here.
So this is the art gallery.
Rawr, bitch. It's the things from Jurassic Park. Let's go.
It's closed due to special circumstances.
The murder occurred only about a month ago. But I'm certain
what was that
crime scene is
like far away.
The others.
Not I that it my matters to me.
But wait! It's not a good idea to break into the art gallery.
Bro, watch them do it anyway. Not bitch.
Did you say something?
Like,
that's our Hellora.
Not even going to acknowledge our
please. The
crime
scene is deep inside the art gallery. It's one of many storage rooms.
Okay, well, let's find
Come.
It.
I won't allow time to be wasted.
Wait, please.
Didn't you just hear what they said? They're not going to wait. Any hoosies. Art gallery. A premier art museum in Kanaiwara, located in Gima District. This dinosaur. Lord, I can't speak. Okay. Ooh, what's here? Locked door.
Oh!
Seems like this door is locked.
Well?
There are priceless works of art all over the place. Of course the door is gonna be locked. No, ship Sherlock, let's go. Oh, detective points though. Okay, I'm ready, Laura. Let's do this.
Is this the storage room where the crime scene took place?
Nah, it's where my grandma picks her cookies. Let's go.
We're going in.
Just kicks the door. Yo. I feel like Alora does a lot of leg day, and I love them for that.
They're like a couple of thugs or something.
Bugging it up. Thug life, let's go. breaking doors down, ripping caution tape. What is that painting supposed to symbolize?
First on the scene, the person from the church again?
As expected, it's the same worshiper. Hmm. He said he was trailing the victim after finding a doll with the same name.
It's like,
he saw the victim enter the building late at night.
It's just something about him. The fact you can't see his eyes.
He then searched the premises with the art gallery staff. When they opened this storage room, they discovered the victim's corpse. The door was locked at the time of discovery, and the key was found inside.
Ooh, another locked room mystery! That's four total!
Indeed it is. You can count.
But I'm starting to get bored. It's not so special anymore.
Bro,
what do you mean special? People have died. Let's start investigating.
Alright, let's do it.
Yes.
Alright, investigation time. There we go. Alright, so save the body for last. We're going to investigate over here first. Blank canvas. The canvas placed here is completely blank. I wonder why it's blank and why it's so messily placed with these wooden frames.
Well,
doesn't look like the exhibition. It doesn't look like an exhibition piece, or you know what I mean. Maybe it was used for some other event. I see. Nothing seems out of place. I don't think this will help with the case. Okay, good to know. A painting of someone screaming.
This is
a painting of a man screaming with his hands clutching his face. There's something unnerving about this painting. It almost feels as if it's going to swallow me whole.
That's.
Paintings don't have that kind of power. More importantly, did you find anything? No, nothing suspicious. It doesn't look like it's related to the case. Then let's keep moving. Let's see. I wonder if the ring that
post-cognition reveals the crime scene in slightly faded colors.
Okay.
The
She's
room
kinda
looked
pretty.
Vaguely hazy in my eyes, even with the rows of vivid paintings within the art gallery. The smell of paint oil that permeated the room wasn't that of the past, but the present. If even the smells from the past could be recreated, the stench of the corpse would be much more overwhelming.
I mean, you know what? I was about to say something, and I feel like I shouldn't say it. Okay, so this is probably gonna be really weird, and that laugh was because it's a little bit of a nervous laugh, right? It's probably gonna be so. What I was going to say was this: I was gonna be like, you know, it's weird because I don't know, maybe I'm someone that usually has a strong sense of smell, is like can be like affected by things. Maybe because it was she wasn't okay. How do I explain this? Long story short, when grandmother died, I kinda had to sit there with them for a little bit. So, I mean, you know what? I'm gonna shut up. I'm just gonna shut up. Nervous laughter this evening. Anyway, blank canvas.
Yeah.
A blank canvas, and hidden frame had been placed on the trolley. Nothing seemed to have changed between then and now, at least that's how it looks to me. It appears unchanged to me as well, meaning there's probably no evidence to be found here. Okay, another screen painting. Alright, we're gonna get out of post-cognition. Let's step away from this. It was over up there at that point. That's why I was like, wait a minute, how are there two? I forgot I, went to a different mode. What's this art even supposed to end? What does this mean? Alright, I'll check it. Alright. Stack boxes.
Hmm?
I feel like the hmms that Yuma does are just so much louder than any other voice line he does, but maybe that's just me. The cardboard boxes are stacked up. Judging from the labels, the boxes were brought in after the incident.
It appears.
Looks like there's artwork inside. They must be storing the items no longer on exhibit. I don't think these are related to the investigation. Okay. Post-op mission, let's see what we got. Anything different? Okay, that's not there anymore. That's not over there anymore. And that there. Old looking painting.
This is...
Just ruin artwork, why don't you, as you make a crime scene. Like, bro, why? It's a portrait painting with manuscript into it. This picture really conveys the time, its time period. Maybe the person depicted it is an important figure from years ago.
What?
Huh? There's nothing dignified about this guy. He just looks like some regular old geezer. Alright, fair enough.
You know.
The cardboard boxes are stacked up. Judging from the labels, there are artworks inside.
Yeah.
There's a layer of dust in the boxes. It doesn't look like the culprit touched them. Meaning they've got nothing to do with the case. Okay. Alright, that's it for this area, I guess. So far, no solution keys yet.
I'll find out for you!
Let's see, what's up here? Examine shelf with basket. Sculpture covered with cloth.
Oh!
A sculpture with a sheet placed over it keeps dust off.
It appears.
Doesn't look like it's been moved for a long time. Yeah, you can tell from the dust that's gathered on the sheet, too. In other words, it's completely irrelevant. Alright. But I'm still... Alright, I love how I said that when I'm the one who read the line. It's like, you ain't gotta be so happy about it. It's like, bro, I'm the one who said it. So it's like... There are baskets on the top shelf. I'm not tall enough to see inside them, though. I'll take a look for you. This is... What is it? We... accomplished nothing. Like... Oh, shit. So you found nothing. Alright, let's see. Post-cop mission. Let's go. Try to be thorough here. Like, check everything. Dot your I's, cross your T's, all that jazz. There are baskets on the top shelf.
What?
There's nothing but dust inside. I guess it hasn't been used for a while. Basically, it's irrelevant to the case. Okay. Nail pierced painting. Another ruined piece of artwork.
There's a nail stuck in a painting.
Actually, there are three. If you count Yuma, you'll see. 1, 2, 3. Go back to Sesame Street. Learn how to count.
The killer must have hammered a nail into the portrait instead of a doll.
But why? That's different. All the other cases had dolls. And one could argue... No, because they started off with dolls. Because the first case was a club, then it was the mansion. But now you're using paintings here. I get it, it's an art museum, but why change the MO? And then go back to using dolls on a clock tower. Like, what the... Okay.
Why is there such a fixation on dolls?
But you're looking at a painting, like, okay, alright.
The crime scenes so far have all been abnormal. But this one's just sick and twisted.
They're all sick and twisted. They're all that way. Hmm. Oh shoot, my sub goal was still there. I just realized. Get that out of here. Hold on. I just saw it. Okay, be gone. There we go. We're gonna exit that out. There we go. A nail is driven into the portrait, perhaps in place of a doll. Okay. We're gonna look there. Okay, sculpture covered with cloth.
Oh!
It's a sculpture with a sheet. Over it. The position was the scene before and after you see post-cognition.
I see.
The overall shape of the sheet is also unchanged. There we go. We can assume nobody's moved it. The sculpture isn't related to the case. Gosh, I can't read. Or I can read, I just can't speak. And that's the true issue of it all. Okay.
in or out of here besides the door is this window.
Okay.
The window juts out and is used as a vent. It doesn't appear big enough for someone to move through.
That is true. Unless you got some shrinking growing powers, it ain't happening. What's up, dude? It's Polka. Hi, Polka. How you be?
Currently, it opens outward slightly, but there are no other suspicious traces on it.
I'd be good.
It seems
I'd be
impossible
good.
To enter or exit through here.
I'll admit. So, I'm guessing you might also know this, but Tower Fantasy Fun released on PlayStation, so it means I'm able to test it out with a controller. And I am hooked. Like, I like the game, which is hard to do it like on keyboard and play it that way. And I almost canceled Raincoat just to play more Tower of Fantasy. So it's like, game. Become like a villain? Nice, nice. That's good. Alright, so that's been investigated. Alright, so I guess it's time for post-cognition. What we got? Look at us holding hands and it's scandalous. Alright, painting of a young man.
This is...
Nails are driven into the painting of a young man. My thing is, isn't this a cement wall? How hard you gotta be nailing to get... Like, how did you do this? How strong are these nails? How strong is the person that did this? I wanna know. Oh, I know this. He's one of those edgelord protagonists everyone loves for no reason. That's not really the impression of this. Let's see, small window. The window juts out and is used as a vent. It doesn't seem big enough for someone to move through. And then we got, here's a doll. The first, and I think the only doll in this room. Or that was in this room.
A large painting lies on the floor, and a doll is nailed against the canvas.
You know what I've been noticing as well? When it's actually, I feel like this is going to be important because then they actually put voice lines on.
One nail goes through the head, but the nail in the chest also passed through the circular hole on the key's handle.
Okay.
Did the culprit leave the storage room after nailing the doll and key to the painting?
I don't think that's not, no. Me acting so smooth is like my character is dancing, ayo, busting.
It couldn't have been used.
There's gotta be a way.
Well, that's what makes it a locked room mystery.
I feel like this is gonna
sure
be the hardest one to figure
trick.
Out.
And I need to find out what that trick is.
Why, he all sweating. It's alright. We will be big brains. We can do this. A doll nailed to the cloth canvas. The key to the room is also nailed on. Okay. Anything else? Large landscape painting.
This is...
It's a large scenic painting with a doll nailed to it. I wonder how this ended up on the floor. Is there a reason?
That's...
If it's related to the incident, then there's probably a reason. Let's assume that. Alright, so I think I've done everything besides, I think, the door and the body. I'm gonna turn that off.
You better hurry or you'll run out of time.
I'm moving! Gosh darn it. Alright, examine the door. Alright. Pooka, I'm so excited for you to see a mystery labyrinth though. So you can see Shinigami, because I wanted to do it last time, but it's like I wasn't able to.
There are two keys that open this door. Only one of them was inside the room at the time of discovery.
Okay.
The other one was owned by a member of the art gallery staff.
Okay.
That staff member always carried the extra key and used it to enter this room when the corpse was discovered.
Alrighty.
Where was the key found inside
the administrative office? But it's unknown if it was always there. Maybe it was lost and the culprit found it. Or perhaps the culprit secretly stole it.
But like, why?
Either way, the culprit managed to obtain the key somehow.
One key was in the storage
room. My character
room.
Is like the
other
suit.
Key was
I'm
always carried
like
by a staff
and
member.
Smooth like butter. Wait, no. Smooth like butter. Smooth like evil butter.
If the culprit is that staff member, then this wouldn't be a locked room mystery, right?
Why That and why would it be the staff member though? And it's supposed to be the same person.
Why go through the trouble of making it look like a locked room murder if you'd immediately become the first suspect?
That too.
I guess you wouldn't.
Countered.
Yeah, I'm hyped on what Shinigami do. Yeah, Shinigami. And in the mystery lab, be looking, do be looking. You evil buddy. Popcorn. Oh my god. Alright, new key. Two keys can open a door to the art gallery storage room. At the time the body was discovered, one of them was inside the room. Alright, yellow paint.
Oh!
Spilled paint was stained the floor. If we can find out when the spill occurred, we'll know if it's related to our investigation. Okay, so any post-cognition now? So, entrance door. Yeah, so that's technically, yeah, okay. So, I think it's technically the paint.
I've been wondering, did the culprit knock this paint can over? If so, it could have been used for some sort of trick.
What trick?
It's unwise to make up your mind before conducting a proper investigation.
Exactly.
It may have been like this before the murder. Or it could have tipped over when the discovery was first made.
Right.
You got carried away in the hopes of getting complimented. Aren't you an eager little puppy?
Be quiet.
Alright, so I think that's that for that. Alright. Now we just have to investigate the body. Alright, marks of the corpse. Or marks on the corpse.
Oh!
Seemed like this is where the body was at the time of the incident. There's no trace of it anymore, though.
It's me.
Looks like the area's been cleaned up, probably by the peacekeepers or the art gallery staff. I don't think investigating here will turn up any useful information. Post-cognition! Getting scandalous with it! She's pretty! It's a shame she's dead.
As expected.
The victim's name is Isomoe. She used her good looks to have relations with many men.
Oh, ma'am. Okay.
The amount of suspects who could have written her name on the doll is nearly too high to count.
Ma'am!
The victim has those same marks that suggest being strangled to death. Huh? But there aren't any scratches that would have been left from a struggle.
So she didn't struggle?
You noticed as well.
Yeah, there's a wound on the back of her head.
Wait, Hilara said that. Looks they're so deep. Proud of him. So there's also a head wound, which is not the same.
This may be the real cause of death.
So it's not exact. Why would they change it up on the... Like the other victims, there are signs of strangulation, but no wounds from resisting. The sign of blunt force trauma on the back of the head. And signs. Okay, anything else? I guess that's it for that. Alright.
That should be enough.
I'm finishing investigating here. I feel like the full picture is slowly starting to come together. Mayhaps. Alright. Alright, gallery. Okay, alright. I won't get to read that. Okay.
That should do it for the room. Next is the window.
The window?
It would be best to check outside of it.
Man,
go
today's
ahead.
A good day.
I'll stay here.
French toast for dinner? Ayo? That do sound like it's honest. I miss being able to have breakfast. I'm not saying I can't have breakfast for dinner. But we used to like, at least with like my mom and stuff, we used to like do it more often. You know what, that's what I'm gonna ask for tomorrow night's dinner. Or maybe I'll just make it myself. Be like, yo, it's breakfast for dinner time. Let's do it.
Outside the window? Alright.
Alright. Let's do it. Alright, so I guess I have to go check.
It's fine to inspect the window, but our buddy here really insists you do everything yourself.
How else am I supposed to learn, dang it?
And my master does everything he's told, like a good little underling detective.
I thought that they were gonna say something different, but we ain't gonna talk about it.
Hilara is right. This is something I took on myself. I can't just rely on everyone else after putting on a tough front for that kid.
That's
true. Why I have to do it.
And we gonna do it. We gonna do what it do.
Maybe Halara's just taking advantage of you. It's obvious money is that one's only motivation.
Even so, I think it's the right thing to do as a professional detective.
Gotta learn.
Master, being overly nice for no reason is stupid. It's why you're so deep in debt.
Wow. All right, Shinigami.
I know, but...
What are you mumbling about? Did you check the window?
I'll get right on it.
Right. I'll do it right away.
Yeah, like, we're sitting here wasting time. Like, Scruffy Man is in danger.
Like the window. Could that have anything to do with the locked room?
I go this way. I have to go the other way. Okay. Let's go. Metal Fox. The religion practiced in the church in Kanai, at the church in Kanai War. Its symbol is a spear piercing the crescent moon. The core doctrine is thou shalt not bear old prejudices. And you read the apron, already read about the currency. Master Detective, already read about that. And you want the breakfast be noise. It's easy to make, like scrambled eggs, bacon, sausage, and almonds.
I wonder what Halara discovered.
Freaking
no,
okay, they're French toast, right?
Just having fun pushing you
but
around.
Hear me out.
I
you know like the cinnamon raisin bread? But cinnamon raisin bread
I
French
see.
Toast. Like it slaps.
Here's the window.
No hard heels there. Alright, so we're investigating.
Well, see anything strange?
No, I don't think so.
No, nothing strange about it. I see. Try entering through the window.
Ma'am, do you see how... I mean, well... Halara, do you see how big this guy's head is? It ain't gonna work.
What?
It did not.
Between the gap? That's impossible.
Just try it.
Okay.
Cinnamon rolls are good, I agree. No, so like they have like the cinnamon raisin bread, but then just make it like French toast.
I can't.
Also coffee cake.
I can't even put my arm through this gap. I can stick a finger in, but that's it.
I thought so. Good job. You can return now.
Halara, what?
Huh? Are you sure? Did you figure something out?
I don't think Yuma did. Yuma didn't figure it out.
Did you not?
Well...
No, not at all. What's that about?
Okay, a hinged window used for ventilation. It opens outward. Yuma!
Pay attention, you!
Turn around! And I love- Shinigami had to have seen this person walking up on us. They could have said something. And they said nothing.
Hey! What are you doing here?
Why did they give him that voice?
I'm not doing anything shady.
That does not fit.
I'll call the peacekeepers.
Bro, just say you are a peacekeeper. I'm a peacekeeper.
I'm a peacekeeper.
What? Of Amaterasu Corporation?
Yeah, all that plot twist, he was the murderer. Why did you say it like that? No. Halara, help.
We are special investigators for Amaterasu Corporation. We are currently investigating a case. Civilians must not interfere.
Bro, the confidence.
Huh? Oh, right. I'm sorry.
Hey, Halara. Are you sure it's okay to lie like that?
Do you want to get in trouble? Then yes.
I told you before that deception is necessary to finish an investigation quickly.
Exactly.
By the way, aren't you an employee here? There's something
I'd
like to ask you.
My boy never got a lie. It's funny. You gotta do what you gotta do.
Can you bring over the staff member who discovered the body from that murder case a month ago?
Oh, that would be me.
Well, that's convenient.
Perfect. Describe the events for us.
Okay.
I'm scared to even remember it, but if it's part of the investigation...
His voice does not fit this character. It's killing me.
I'll leave the rest up to you.
Sure.
Okay. Alright.
Gosh, you're short. Please tell us what happened on the day of the murder.
That day, I was doing my closing procedures when someone from the church appeared.
Why he start getting even more like soul-like? Like he's just like, that day, I was doing what I do, you know?
He said he wanted me to help him find someone, and that he knew the person was inside the art gallery. So we looked around the premises together, but didn't find anyone.
Why would she even go to the art gallery, though?
According to him, there was a chance that the person he was looking for was being pursued by the nail man.
He just keeps sounding more like soul, like sultry, like not soul, but like a smooth jazz, like a, you know what I mean? No, maybe.
I couldn't help but feel terrified when I heard.
Terrified. Like,
how did you notice something was off about the storage room?
The lights were on, even though they were usually off. So I went to take a look. The door was locked, so I opened it with the key.
You have to do ASMR or like something. It just sounds so relaxing, though.
But I was afraid to go any further.
It seems like it's just progressively getting.
So I let the church person go first and open the door while I watched from behind. And then there was a corpse.
Did you touch the body?
Corpse husband? Let's go. I'm kidding.
Of course not. I was too afraid and froze at the entrance.
What about the churchgoer?
He saw what happened at the doorway and didn't go any further.
Are you positive you didn't touch anything inside after unlocking the door?
Yes, but...
But?
The churchgoer accidentally kicked a paint can over when he opened the door.
Okay.
And paint spilled all over the floor.
So that paint was from back then.
Okay. I get the picture. Thank you.
Oh, right.
Alright, I guess that's that. At the time the body was discovered. That should be discovered, not discovery. But anyway, someone from the church tried to enter and knocked over the paint can.
That brings all the information together.
Poca, it's time!
It's time to resolve the case.
Let's do it!
Wait! I still have no idea what happened!
Dang, Yuma, that sounds like a you problem, and by that, it's also a me problem.
Our deadline is approaching. You hurry back to the detective agency.
Okay.
Huh? What about you?
Worry not. When you're in trouble, say my name.
Bet.
Pilar Nightmare shall rush to your aid.
I guess that's why the body was covered in purple paint.
What are you gonna do, Master?
No, that's the blood. The paint that spilled was yellow.
We checked everything we can. All that's left is to point out the true culprit, but...
If only it were that easy. I have no clue what to
like,
do.
Like, some of the locker room mysteries I figured out, so I feel like. But
why don't we go back to the detective agency for now? We might get to see Fuzzhead get executed.
No, I don't want to die.
Right, we need to help him.
But the one, I think, for the one for the art gallery and the one for the mansion, I'm a little, just a tiny bit lost. Crosswalks are kind of okay. All right.
I need to hurry back before the chief gets executed.
Okay.
Right, let's hurry.
Hey,
I
want to
know how they'll execute him too.
Bro, Shinigami, I swear. I don't want the scruffy man to die. He's a character that I actually like. Oh, Fubuki! I think that's that chick's name. Yeah, if she died, I'd be like, you know, but, you know. They see me running. They hating. Running through the rain, trying to catch me running dirty. I also still have Tower of Fantasy just up, and I'm just still, like, in the same position, like, about to take off on my jetpack. I just haven't done it. There's been a few people that have just like walked by and are like, what the, like they'll stop, run around, and be like, yo, this person good, and then just go fuck off. Hopefully no one needs an enemy to return, because someone's done that before, and then I was in a fight, or I was trying to fix my weapons and stuff, and it was just like, you can't do that, you're in a fight, and I'm like, bro, what? And they led an enemy towards me. And just kind of sat there, and I went out of like the menu, and it was trying to attack me. I'm like,
hurry, or
what was the reason?
Will really be in danger.
I can read maps. I can do this. Hold on. I can do this. I have to find a sewer thing. Where? Okay, here. I can go down here.
Halara seems to know who the real culprit is.
Oh.
That's incredible.
Come Come on! Where's your competitive spirit? You might be a trainee, but you're still a detective.
Am I though? Alright, let's go. Riverbank. The Scarfew guy, did smoke on the sub. He did. Even though he's like, yeah, I'm trying to quit smoking. No open fires allowed. And then continuously smokes on the submarine. Like, dude, a little hypocritical. But, you know. Amaterasu Corporation. Many products are in development, some of which cannot be made public. Peacekeepers are part of the Amaterasu Corporation. Okay, alright. He's just pacing around in circles. All the flowers are wilted. Oh no. Make sure it's on.
There
you go.
It's about time.
I just cast them away.
Hey, wait! You said I had 3 hours, huh? My watch says I still got 5 minutes!
I got 5 minutes! He count down to the minute, the second, the millisecond. It ain't time yet.
You need to get your watch repaired.
Bruh.
Oh dear. The watchmaker is currently detained.
So y'all know his profession.
Just throw away that piece of trash then.
Yo, sir, listen here, you mop head monocle wearing mofo. Don't you kill my scruffy.
Besides, you're out of time anyway.
And he got 5 minutes.
Take him away.
No. Why is he creeping up on him like that?
Yuma! I knew you'd save me!
Oh, he sounds like he's about to cry. I'm crying.
And you are.
Your worst nightmare. Freaking Cocohead.
I was the one investigating the Nail Man murders.
Oh, I see. So, you're the one who interfered with our work at the clock tower.
Your work, y'all.
Honor your courage for confessing, and turn a blind eye to that incident. You must drop this case. If you do, we will leave without pursuing any further action.
I think not.
That'd be the ideal solution for all of us. What do you say?
No.
Yuma, think carefully about this.
Be creeping. So they do.
Solving the case is good and all, but think about my well-being. Please.
Oh, it's okay. I got you. You'll be safe.
Dropping the case would end this peacefully, but still.
Please, get my dad back from them.
Yeah, he got a son. We gotta save the papa.
You may be a trainee, but you are still a detective. Once you have accepted a job, you must finish it.
Mm-hmm.
I can't back down now. The Nail Man killings haven't been solved yet. I will find the truth.
Look at us. Look at him being all confident, somewhat.
Huh?
Hey, you've said it now. There's no pulling out of this one anymore.
Then our deal is off. He comes with us. This is for directly interfering with our work and bringing strife to
come. No.
But
I'm so scared.
Please wait before you go.
Mm-hmm.
Please listen to what I've discovered while investigating the past Nail Man killings.
Mm-hmm.
You investigated the previous killings. We handle all the information for those cases.
We gotta do a
now
poor
that they're
job.
Closed, there's nothing left at the crime scenes. I have no time for your lies.
Ain't no lies.
The Peacekeeper report didn't say anything about the cause of death.
Mm-hmm.
All of the victims were strangled to death, weren't they? I suspect this fact hasn't been made public.
He do be a protag. He do be.
How did you know that?
Cause I'm smarter than you.
So the cause of death was kept under wraps. I hope my investigation is legitimate.
I feel like that's not going to make him change his mind, though. The victims of the serial killings were all strangled, but the cause of death was not publicized.
Please, let me continue. I will catch the true culprit.
They don't want you to do that, though, hun.
I don't know where you obtained that information. However,
from your mama. Anyway,
it appears that you must be arrested as well.
Sir.
You are suspected of espionage.
That...
I believe...
Wow.
Wait, please listen to me!
They're not going to listen. Look at his little hands as he panics.
You all too carried away, rookie.
Well, worry not. This is where we die.
When you're in trouble, say my name.
Say my name. When danger is around you, Halara will come save you. Yeah. Say the name.
That's right.
Halara, please help. Halara Nightmare.
It appears you require the aid of a great detective.
Oh, okay, here we go. Where did you come from? Uh-oh. Let's go. He's like, huh? Gee, Lord. Gosh darn.
Halara, you came for me.
Yeah. As I said,
well, Lollipop and Toll are hilarious.
You committed acts of violence against the Amaterasu Corporation peacekeepers. Not once, but twice.
Sorry! I promised to give him a stern lecture after
this. Need some backbone.
Can we please keep things on the down low?
On the down low.
Are you alright?
Are you alright?
Who do you think we are? In this town, we're...
Nobody's.
You are nothing but an audience.
Excuse me?
Right now. The leading role belongs not to you or me, but to you.
Excuse me? Wait.
Me? I'm the lead guy here?
Yeah, you're the protagonist
set
of the game.
The stage for you to solve the case. The time has come for you to risk it all as a detective.
Okay.
Expose the true culprit.
Hello? All right, pointing at moi.
What's going on?
Oh, okay, and they're here too.
I don't know why I was brought here. Can I go home?
Hi, ma'am.
So that's what you meant about setting the stage. I mean, Halara did suggest the real killer was among the people at the church.
Mm-hmm.
And now I have to point them out here?
Hey, you
know, it's the priest.
Are you sure you got this?
That's who I think it is.
Are you really... really sure?
It's a priest.
There's no room
That's
to mess up here.
That's who I think
here.
It is.
You
I don't
know?
Trust him.
Ask for more time here.
They wanted to be the worshiper, but I just, it's a vibe. I'm feeling off of him, and that's what I'm going off of.
Yeah, I don't think so. Halara seems to know the answer already, so why don't you just pay up for it?
No.
But that would waste all of Halara's efforts setting the stage for me.
Huh. So you want to solve this all on your own?
Just open the gosh darn labyrinth, will you?
If you can't ask Halara for help, why don't you try asking me instead?
Just open the labyrinth. Oh, what was that quote from, freaking Dr. Phil? Was like, open the door. Oh, what is it? Open the door. What is it? Maybe I'll play it at the end. I don't know.
You mean the mystery labyrinth?
Yes.
The peacekeepers aren't just gonna stand by and listen to your deduction here. Things are just gonna escalate, and it might even end up with more deaths.
Okay.
Oh no.
And that's where yours truly comes in.
Mm-hmm.
We have the information we need from the investigation. All that's left is to solve the case with the mystery
labyrinth. Pull the lever, Crunk. Wrong lever!
But if I do that...
There's always a price to pay. When I reap the soul of the true culprit, the mystery labyrinth created by the culprit is destroyed.
Okay.
But as a price, the source that created the mystery labyrinth also perishes.
It's okay. Which you gotta worry about it. Don't worry.
The real culprit will die.
It's alright, BBK.
Huh?
Don't worry about it.
This killer's a total psycho who's already killed many others. Why do you care if you want to solve this case, Master? What about your promise to that
the
kid?
The three... the arrows... and the... on the... and the 3D... the ghost... You know what? We're not gonna talk about it. We're just not...
What's wrong, Yuma?
What is this nonsense about a resolution? I don't have time for this.
Just let me...
I will make you listen by force if needed.
Dang.
That is my job as assistant.
You better hurry. Or things
you don't
want to
gotta open the thing!
Here.
Open it!
Fine.
open it.
That's the spirit. Well, master, are you mentally
prepared? Are you ready? It's gonna be the picture of the thumbnail in a hot second. Oh, here we go, Poco, here we go. Let's go, sis. Cause they want them, cause they want them to go to court. But see, look, what? It's Shinigami. And that's what I was like, kinda twinning. A little bit, not really, but, you know? Shinigami be acting like, just a little bit, just a tiny bit, you know? He's just like, you know what? Well, Blake, just look. Fuzzy yet. I can't.
What's this?
Oh, shoot. Laura.
Has time stopped?
Laura, how are you moving right now?
Yuma, what happened? Is this someone's forte?
It's ours.
Shinigami, Laura's in here too.
I love her outfit so much.
You knew this would happen?
Master, you used your coalescence, remember? Your ability isn't a one-way street. You have the power to borrow someone's abilities, and you share yours as well.
Oh, okay. I mean, makes sense,
Kalara,
you know.
Kalara wandered into the mystery labyrinth because of that effect. I think.
You think? Ma'am? How do you not know?
You're even sure?
Who are you?
This'll take too long to explain. Plus, I don't feel like it.
Bruh, just like, I don't feel like it. Wait, stop! Wait, no! Oh, no! Just said, boop, just a casual kick. Alright, so what we're gonna do is we're going to. Wait, did I not save a space for the. Wait. No, okay, we're good. So this is gonna be for this mystery labyrinth. Like I said, once I finish this, do walkthroughs for each mystery labyrinth. So that's how that's gonna be. And then post videos for that. Master Detective, let's see, means of communication. Most communications to people outside Kanawa are tapped and monitored by Amaterasu. The phone of the Nocturnal Detective Agency uses. Okay, alright. I still won't be able to finish reading all of that. Now see, the mystery labyrinth, I thought it had the animals and stuff just because of, freaking, Zilch, but I guess it just always looks like this on the outside. Just the inside is the only thing that changes.
Where am I? What should I do? I'll need to explain everything, won't I?
We don't have much of a choice now. No point in keeping secrets here.
Okay.
Halara, let me explain.
All right. Okay, zoom, 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 explaining.
And that's how this mystery labyrinth involving the Nailman killings materialized.
All right.
I see.
I'm glad they don't make us have to see you all.
Are materialization of mysteries themselves, and the truth is encased deep within.
Correct mundo.
I appear to have underestimated you. This is an amazing forte.
I mean, technically we can say it's Yuma's forte, you know, a little bit, maybe?
I must admit, it's quite a superhuman power. As far as I know, no other ability comes close to this.
What do you mean?
Who are you? I refuse to think you're just a trainee detective.
Don't worry about it.
To be honest, this isn't my.
Bro, you could have just said it was your ability. You have, you know, like. hype yourself up a little bit, you know?
Before you continue, tell me, who is that woman beside you?
Her name is Shinigami. I think the simplest way to describe her is that she's a guide for the Mystery Labyrinth.
Okay.
That's me! I'm also Master Scaricute Mentor.
Alright, sure.
On to my next question.
Just like, okay, cool, answer that question. Moving on.
You're just gonna ignore me?
Basically.
You mentioned the Nailman case just now. I had heard the rumors about that around town.
Oh, don't tell me.
Why are you investigating that case?
Oh, no.
Huh? What are you talking about?
So they don't remember-
We're just investigating the Nailman case together.
The Nailman. We were pursuing that case together?
Oh, Christ. I mean, I guess it makes sense because they knew the answer, so I guess to protect the I don't know. Plot twist, is the son of the detective leader or corporation's corporate son? What do you mean by that? Like the culprit? See, I like to think Yuma's maybe somehow connected to
him. There was a young boy who wanted to hire a detective, and you turned him down.
That's my theory.
I do remember you received a request from a child about some case, and you ended up seeking my help.
Bruh.
The cost for hiring me was $5,500,000.
You remember that, but not okay. All right, Holara.
You remember the exact amount,
but I can't remember what the case involved. I do vaguely. My mind is clouded. I don't remember exactly what was being investigated or what was discovered.
Okay.
Could that be?
Never mind, though. By the way, he doesn't remember yet. So I guess it's up to us. Never mind again. What do you mean?
Yeah, it's because of the Mystery Labyrinth. The Mystery Labyrinth is a fortress protecting the truth, so outsiders usually can't reach it. If someone did happen to wander in, their memories of the case would be locked away.
Oh, so that's why we have the keys, I guess.
So, if you have a pact with me, you wouldn't be affected.
Okay, or that too.
But I guess that part of the pact can't be shared.
This is the Mystery Labyrinth's defense mechanism, then.
Wait, if she forgot the case, wait, then they do not get to this. I mean, we kind of just openly admitted that they helped us, so... They still... I don't know.
It makes sense for a vault that protects its treasure, the truth, to have a significant level of security.
God damn it.
Yep, totally not strange at all. Halara here sure is smart.
If they don't know what it was, then they don't need to...
Halara...
Oh, like, oops. Don't mind her. She gives people random nicknames.
Anyway, since my memories of the case have been taken away, I will provide a supporting role for your investigation.
That's they've already been doing.
Supporting role?
As long as we're in here, I will act as
your
assistant.
The only thing is, Polka, I think maybe
that's the same as our original agreement.
I think only because that we're in the Mystery Labyrinth, that's why the memories are gone. I feel like once we're out, maybe they'll come back. Maybe.
That means we can't rely on Halara's detective skills to blast through this dungeon. That's unfortunate, but it's still nice to have an ally.
Okay.
Hey, Master. Before we head into the Mystery Labyrinth, let's do that thing.
Do that thing? Alright,
huh? What thing?
Do the thing, whatever it is. Hello.
Master, are you ready to give your life for the truth?
I mean, sure, pop off, I guess. Let's do it.
Yeah, I am.
Oh, she's so pretty. I don't know why, but this is so cute to me. Oh, okay. Whee! Man, I miss ball. Especially the dancing I did like. I mean, I did like tap dancing as well, so for those that don't know, I did 90s dance group. Tap dancing and ballroom dancing was that shit. So, two of my favorites.
It's just
just full of surprises.
Indeed it is.
I assume that sword is used to cut down enemies interfering with your progress through the mystery labyrinth?
Indeed it is.
You're right. It's a special sword that can interact with things here.
I better materialize the solution keys I got during the investigation too.
Let's do it. Oh, I forgot she throws them up. Oh god.
That was a lot. Here you go.
Do you have to vomit them out every time?
Yuma asked the same thing the first time around.
What? Should I use a different hole instead?
Excuse me? No.
Sorry, please don't mind her.
Alright, we're all set. Now, let's unriddle this mystery labyrinth. Our target is the true culprit who preys on the truth.
Let's do it. Alright, here we go.
I understand that progressing through this mystery labyrinth will allow us to obtain the truth. Mm-hmm. But what happens to us if we can't find it?
That's a good
question.
We'd
be lost, wandering around here forever.
Alright.
But as long as we reach the truth, it doesn't matter how much time we spend here.
I think that's the one thing I like about it. There isn't a specific time limit.
Oh, I forgot to mention
that's
cool. There's a time limit for solving the mystery labyrinth.
Motherfucker!
Oh, what?
There's a limit to how long you can stay.
Why didn't you say that in the beginning? Ma'am.
Your soul will wander until it's eventually absorbed by the mystery labyrinth.
Ma'am.
In other words, you die.
Why are you laughing? You should have told me this a long time ago.
Oh, relax. Quit whining. A detective is bound to die anyway.
Wow, okay.
Isn't that right, Helara?
It's no different from our usual.
Really having fun with that nickname, isn't it?
A detective's life is always on the line.
See? Listen up, Master. You might learn something.
You're taking this awfully well, Helara.
I feel like Helara, like, I don't know. Helara just be going with the flow at this point. Alright. Come on. Alright, there we go. Please don't change the scenery anymore. Let's move on. Let's progress. Let's do what it do, Yugi. You can stop time, yet your memory. Wait. Get your meal ticket.
What's
this? Wait, what? Is in your body? Okay, now we're in a weird forest with dolls and okay, alright.
They seem to represent the four crime scenes.
Okay.
I assume that solving all four will allow us to progress.
Alright.
Oh, I see.
And that's about it.
Your job. So what's first? How about starting with the clock tower, since it was-
Logically, then the clock tower would be the fourth locked room mystery.
Indeed it would be. Alright, so we're gonna go here. Let's solve this thing.
Are you going to the fourth locked room?
Are you going to the fourth locked room?
Yes. Vivian.
This is an exact replica of the clock tower crime scene.
Okay.
Shinigami, you didn't recreate it with your powers, did you?
No, I can only do that when I hit you so hard in the head you almost die.
Bro, why? But why does it have to be that way? Why so much violence?
It looks to me like the crime scene materialized in the labyrinth on its own.
No, we're getting pizza with bread rolls? No more breakfast for dinner?
The fourth locked room is the latest chronologically, correct?
That's right. And this is also what got me involved in the mailman killings.
Okay. What are the details of the case? Try to tell me as concisely as possible.
Okay.
The crime was a locked room murder inside the storage room of a clock tower. In the middle of the room was a woman's corpse covered in countless nails.
Okay.
Which means that's the corpse.
Indeed it is.
Yeah. There were also lots of dolls nailed to the walls.
Well, now he's just kind of stating the obvious. Yeah, tardy for breakfast.
It looked just like one of those bizarre crime scenes left
but
behind.
But you're
by
looking
that
at it right now. Stop
legend.
Stating the obvious. Let's just
and
get
the
on with the solving part.
From the look of it, the door was locked from the inside.
Mm. Yeah, it was locked until the body was discovered.
There's only one window, and its shutters were down as well.
Okay.
I see. So the shutters were locked too.
This is the third
but
floor.
But this
clock
one
tower.
I feel like again
it's
is
too
like
high
the
up
easy
to jump from
to
here.
Solve. Hmm. Like even as I was going
so
through
really
the investigation,
is a locked room
so mystery.
Hey, if this is a locked room, aren't we stuck in here too?
Ma'am. Reason. Hey, yeah, like, why are you doing this? Hey, hey now. Huh? Where did the culprit flee from?
I see. So that's how to make the question.
Just calm and collected about it, like, no biggie, you know?
I'm surprised you're so calm after seeing that.
Alright, where did the culprit flee from? Spot selection. My hypothesis or thought pattern is that it has to be the window, cause it ain't the door.
Here.
Yeah, this one, like I said, it one and four are probably the easiest to solve, because I think I got the gist of it from just investigating. Two and three, however, are gonna
the
be
the culprits must have escaped through the window.
And your reasoning?
When I arrived at the scene, the window shutters were closed. It was wet underneath the window, but I could tell it was already starting to dry.
Which means the window was open not too long ago.
Exactly.
It's likely the culprit escaped through the window and closed the shutters on the way out.
Is it possible to close the shutters from the outside?
The weight of it closes itself and then locks itself.
This style of shutter automatically locks, so if you let go of the shutters at the right
height. So
would
it only be the main protagonist's blood or everything can join in? What do you mean by that?
Its momentum pulls it down, and once down, it locks all on its own.
Like, what do you mean? Or like, when it did the thing to pull up the questions, if you're referring...
In other words...
But if you're not afraid of that,
held up the shutters while moving outside. Once they let go, it automatically locked.
In that case, let's try leaving this locked room in the same way.
Right. Let's try it.
Okay. But you need a way to get down. Okay. Hello.
The Nailman killings have already been solved.
Oh my god, not them making him a whole bush head.
Is he that peacekeeper?
Just
it's
like,
a mystery phantom. The people covering up the case in the real world are manifested like that here to stop us.
He's about to pull him out the car, digging in our window.
You think the culprit really escaped from here, this high up?
I think so.
If you fall, you die.
What
Why
a
don't you give it a try?
Listen here, you thorny, colorful. Hey, hey now.
Help!
At least they're trying. Oh no, because we're tethered together. Don't grab Alara!
Hey, don't drag me down with you.
We can't leave the guest behind,
Alara. Bro, Shinigami's foul for that. If that's how you get a question, blood, does anyone's blood... No. So it has to be Yuma's. It's Yuma's. Oh, shoot. Okay, is this a quick time event?
Yuma, the mystery is a manifestation of a mystery. So solving it will get us out of this, right?
Hypothetically speaking, yes.
I think so.
The culprit wouldn't have fallen out of the window like we did. They would need a tool to get up and down.
And I think I know what that tool is.
A tool?
You should have found something during the investigation.
I did indeed.
I was helping you, after all. You must have seen the answer with your own eyes. Try to remember.
I did. I think I know exactly which one it is. Let's go. All right, how's this going? Okay. What does the culprit use to escape from the high location? Whoa! Wait, no! I meant to say. Wait, what? Oh, okay. Quick time event. Okay, let's go. Okay, wait. Okay, I'm trying. What does the culprit use to escape from the high location? What option are you giving me? What was that? Burnt remains of strange bird. Yes.
That's it. We found the burnt remains of that rope in the incinerator at the church.
Exactly.
The culprit had used that rope to escape through the window.
Mm-hmm. What traces did using the rope leave behind? Wet floor. Nope. Nope. Yes.
Oh,
what?
It.
How was that not it? I pressed Y. That should be it. What else could it be? What traces did using the rope leave behind? Wet floor. No. Shutter structure. No. I hit Y. Ain't no way I didn't hit that in time.
The nail that was stuck in the doll under the window had some rub marks on it.
Exactly.
The culprit must have tied the rope there. That's why those nails have been hammered in below the window.
It wouldn't be possible to climb down a rope simply hooked onto a window. Unless you've had special training for it.
Special training.
There's no way an amateur could manage it. That can't be how things went down.
Trust believe that it did.
In that case, it couldn't have been an ordinary rope. It must have been...
Huh?
What's that? I can't hear you!
What were the rope's burnt remains originally? Oh, shit. Okay, what are you giving me? Safety line, rope ladder. Rope ladder. What's the button for rope ladder? X! Let's go! Alright. Okay. She's just like... Love how Halara just... And then just floats down.
Wow. We're alive, I think.
Okay.
Yuma, are you okay?
Yeah, thanks. You saved me, Halara.
Look at Halara caring about us.
Correct. It's all thanks to me. Money well spent, no?
Now, wait a minute. This case, Halara wasn't even involved yet. No, this was my own thinking powers.
Well, it was a lot of money.
You two just gonna keep staring at each other all day? Let's get out of this locked room!
Right.
So this is the rope ladder in question.
Mm-hmm.
It certainly would help you escape.
Okay.
The details of the case are still unclear to me. Was this found in the church's incinerator?
It was indeed. Just doing a little thingy thing here.
That's right. It didn't concern me at the time, but it makes sense now.
Okay.
The rope can be folded in the middle, and then the ends can be connected together. And that's how they made a rope ladder.
What makes you so sure it was used here?
Because
the nail under the window showed signs
and
of friction from a rope. And had some yellow fibers on it. A clergy member showed me the rope's burnt remains, and I noticed it was the same yellow color.
Mm-hmm.
And there were footprints on the ground below the window of the clock tower, facing the wall.
Exactly.
Thinking about it now, these were clearly signs that someone climbed down the rope ladder and landed there.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, wasn't the rope ladder hitched on that nail? How did they get it down
Just
from the
cut
bottom?
The nail.
The culprit could have cut it one rung at a time as they descended. By the
exactly.
time they reached the bottom...
And then you just give it a little key
one
hole.
Long single rope, which they could easily pull down.
And you just go burn that bad boy.
The window shutters fell due to its weight and locked automatically, completing the locked room.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, that's a stellar deduction. Major props.
Thank you. Just let me have something, dang it. And my thing is, too, another thing with the footprints is that they were locals. And there's only one female worker at the church. I don't think it's her, and I don't want
to
be
escape
her.
The clock tower. What of it?
But I'm just saying.
Change.
Master, boom, kill the mystery phantom blocking your path!
You got it.
Yeah!
Alright, let's do this. Oh my gosh, OBS, stop crashing. Gonna die, Why is that song stuck in my head? Alright, let's do this. Alright, what keys do you give me here? Clock Tower, Fear of Heights. Oh, that's it. Oh, because I'm leveled up.
Yours are unnecessary.
Okay, wait, how do I rebuttal? Rebuttal is X. The culprit is. A is a slash, though, it's okay.
The Watchmaker was nearby at the time of the crime.
Okay. So it's gotta be his Fear of Heights.
The Watchmaker was also at the scene.
Duck.
And he had a hammer for the nails.
Oh, jump! Okay.
In other words, he committed the crime. After committing the crime.
Up.
Just as you deduced, he that locked room.
Wait, no, that's the wrong thing. God darn it! Hi, Spieler! I fucked up.
Say.
Damn it, that's not what I meant to refute. How you be?
Right.
God damn it, I messed up.
These deductions of yours are unnecessary.
Nope.
It's clear he culprit is.
Nope.
The Watchmaker was nearby at the time of the crime.
Whoop. Dodge that.
The Watchmaker was also at the sea.
Duck.
And he had a hammer for the nails.
Jump.
In other words, he committed the crime.
Nope. Not it.
After committing the crime.
Duck.
Just as you deduced,
nope.
He created
not
that locked room. And escaped via the rope ladder.
Nope, he's afraid of heights. Get that out of here.
The truth. Watchmaker is afraid of heights. He couldn't even look out the windows as he went up the tower.
Exactly.
No way he climbed a rope ladder that high up. So it's impossible for him to have committed the crime. He's not the nail man.
Damn you!
Bro, it just took one hit to make it. Bro, you're weak sauce.
You Get said these brain. Mystery phantoms try to cover up the case, right? Which means the Peacekeeper Seth is trying to do just that.
Exactly.
I don't know why, but it's clear the Peacekeepers are involved with this case.
I feel like they were doing something with the church. I wouldn't put it past them.
Perhaps it is connected to Kanai Ward's ultimate secret.
Could be.
All the more reason to seize the truth. Let's go.
Right.
Be. How you be, Spieler?
Jeez, who's the protagonist here?
It's Yuma. Most likely, maybe. Although Halara really do be taking a lead there. Chillin' looks good.
By the way, Yuma, about your sword.
I almost dropped my controller.
Does it only...
The solution
Oopsie.
Blade works against anything in the Mystery Labyrinth. So, don't cut your allies by mistake,
Bro,
Master.
Bro, so I could accidentally hurt Halara. That's not good.
You could have told me that sooner. Can I
use
that sword?
Out on the details? I think not.
Ooh, so sorry. Only Master is able to use it, because he made a pact with yours truly.
Yours truly? Like, what?
You may be
under
the effects of coalescence, but you're just an extra here, Halara.
Well, it's great to have you here.
So, no, you can't use the solution blade.
I was merely curious. Regardless, it's best I act as support, since I don't have any memories of what happened.
Mm-hmm.
Let's return to the case.
Okay.
Assuming the Watchmaker isn't the culprit, do you have any notion of who is?
I'm still going off a gut feeling of the priest.
Halara, during the investigation, you claimed one of the people at the church is the culprit. I think I understand the reason why now. That rope was found inside the incinerator, which only clergy members could access.
Exactly. Which is another reason why I don't think it's the worshiper, because he wouldn't have access to that because he's not an actual worker there. And therefore, I don't want it to be the chick, or maybe they're all in on it, who knows. I still think it's the priest. He just gives very shady vibes.
In other words, whoever tried to destroy the evidence is a member of the church.
Exactly.
Prompt and logical. I am quite impressive.
You're really out here tooting your own horn, though. Like, all right, Halara.
Wait, you're tooting your own horn?
God damn it. All right. open.
Hey! A treasure chest! Can I open it?
You say that as you open it. All
check right. it out! A new solution key!
Ooh, what is it? Alright, what we got? Alright, only clergy members have access to the incinerator. That should have already been a key, but okay. Alright, and then just set it ablaze. Hope that the doll is free now, I guess.
Back to the original spot.
So, we cleared the first route.
Hmm.
We just need to keep this up and go through each shrine one by one to gather clues about the culprit.
Indeed we do.
Which supposedly leads to solving the real life
case.
Why
is that doll twitching like that, though?
I'm starting to understand how the mystery labyrinth operates.
Hmm.
You learn fast. Unlike a certain master I know.
Okay, those shots were not. They didn't need to be taken. They just didn't.
You're so impressed. Why don't you just sign a pact with Halara?
Oh, are you sulking? You're the jealous kind, aren't you?
I feel like Shinigami's more the one that gets jealous, though.
No, I'm not.
The way he's saying, no, I'm not sulking, not jealous.
We're short on time, aren't we? Let's move on.
Right.
I can't wait to reap the culprit's soul. What do we do next?
Okay, so I said one is probably
you can choose whichever you want, so why not start with the one you're most confident with?
Which is one, which I'm gonna do. Alright, let's do this. So I feel like one is fairly simple one.
The first locked room happened 6 months ago in a secret club in Kamisaki District.
Mm-hmm.
An old geezer was nailed to the wall in an underground casino. If you think you're up for it, then let's solve this thing.
Are you going to the first locked room?
Are you going to the first locked room?
Yes. Let me in. And drop it. Let's go. Where are we dropping? Let's do it. Let's get her done. Open. Okay.
Oh, did we get trapped inside a locked room again?
Mayhaps.
If the mystery isn't solved, then I
Shinigami,
will escape
please.
This place. Trapped in a cramped room with these two. Sounds kind of fun, actually.
Excuse me?
I have no intention of playing along with your fantasies. Yuma, hurry up and take care of this.
You got it.
Yeah, okay.
Alright, so, okay, then we get slicey-diced again. Where did the culprit flee from?
This is where I used Halara's forte with my coalescence for the first time.
It is indeed.
Postcognition allowed us to see the crime scene as it was in the past. Some things were obvious. Those are most suspicious.
I mean, they do have a casino, Mr. Dice. Okay, where did the culprit escape from? Wrong way. They escaped from up there.
I know. What about the vent?
Because, oh, but the, okay, so not everything is here, but.
You believe the culprit escaped through the vent?
Yes, because I think there were nails, they used that for the support, and they went through there. Again, it's leading to the priest, because, right, so this is narrowing down the suspect, because if they went through the vent, right, and obviously that's the correct choice, because the game didn't, like, be like, no, stupid, you know? It's not the correct choice. It did like little animation and stuff, whatever. If they went through the vent, it has to be, they gotta be nimble and skinny. And it's not the precious potato man. It's not him. Cause he's so freaking precious. He's such a sweetheart. So it can't be him. So, yeah.
Yes, I'm sure of it.
It has to be.
When I saw the crime scene with your postcognition, the screws on the four corners of the vent cover were removed.
Mm-hmm.
Which means the culprit must have escaped from there.
Jesus Christ, why did that scare me? What? The lady is like, hello?
How ludicrous.
Ludicrous is a fun word. Look at the boogity bitch. Hello, you thorny rainbow bitch. What are you doing? Man, my bets were full on, but you know, it must be a small fry. That's what I'm saying.
You're saying the culprit escaped from the vent?
That is exactly what I'm saying.
Master, poke it full of holes until he's a makeshift golf course.
Poke him full of holes. Bet, let's do it.
What does that mean?
What does that mean? Again, there's certain lines that Yuma says that just like, are just perfect. Like, the way he says it and executes it is just beautiful. Beautifully done. Alright, so what are we doing? Which way are they having us do this? Are we dodging? Are we doing quick time? What's going on? Alright, let's see. Alright, so we're dodging. Alright. Let's see, how many keys you giving me? I only have the one key, so nails beneath the bend, which is the correct key, obviously.
How ludicrous. They used the vent.
Duck?
That's utterly impossible.
Jump?
Think, they're pretty high up.
Duck?
There's no way you could get there.
That's wrong.
Even if the cover was removed.
Jump?
There's no foothold to use to reach it.
Oh, slash!
I'll slash through this mystery!
Alright, what else you got for me? Pretty redundant. Let me smack you around some more. Downward.
The culprit used the nails driven into the wall as footing to nails to bend.
That noise! What is that noise? Like, what the... Alright, there he goes again. Okay.
So you're forced to fight this way every time. Quite the test of endurance.
Indeed it is. Just want to slash and get it, slash and hack and slash and get it done, but you know.
However, solving the mystery itself was simple. The nails were used as footing to escape through the vent.
Mm-hmm.
Did you find that out using my post-cognition?
Indeed we did. Are you about to pat yourself on the back again, Halara?
Yeah.
No, not the time.
Without your help, this case would have been impossible to solve.
You'll never be considered a full-fledged detective until you can handle a case like this on your own.
Well, we kinda technically needed the forte. We can't see in the past. Like, it's okay to ask others for help. What the heck?
Sorry.
Why are you apologizing?
You got lectured again. Sucks to be a rookie, huh?
Bro, what the?
Anyway, let's head out. We'll use the nails on the wall as footing, just like you deduced.
Alrighty.
Right, let's hurry.
Wait, what type of... What, huh? Perspective? Okay.
The mystery labyrinth. Such a bizarre place.
It truly do be.
I must ask, is there no way to escape besides solving the mysteries?
You mean like an emergency exit? Unfortunately,
I
don't think that exists.
To the po. Oh wait, the po what? What do you mean?
An emergency exit, huh? Well, there is one.
So there is. Why does she hold out all this information on us?
There is.
But it doesn't solve anything. He'll just go right back to the mess you came from.
Which is fair. Out to the police.
Yes,
yeah, no.
To use the emergency exit, you'll have to pay a heavy, heavy
price.
Well,
is it more of my life gone?
And that is...
Don't worry about it.
Don't
using
worry about
it here wouldn't...
Yeah, there be no police. Only the Amaterasu Corporation and their so-called peacekeepers. And then they suck at their jobs, which is why we must do it for them.
There it is! Another treasure!
Treasure!
So, who's gonna open the treasure chest this time?
Maybe Halara?
How about, whoever looks like they'd win a character popularity poll?
That'd probably be Shinigami, but
oh,
you know.
That's me.
Okay, well, you know what? Yeah.
Alright! Another solution key!
Alright, what's this? Only someone with a slender build could have used the nails as footing to escape the vent. Exactly.
Looks like another clue leading us toward the culprit.
Someone can.
Considering the culprit used those nails as footing, they would have to be nimble.
Exactly.
And given the size of the vent, only someone thin could fit through it.
Exactly again.
So the culprit must be thin. We're narrowing down the possibilities quite nicely.
What a lovely expression Solara makes. Man, why is Scruffy Man opening the chest? He went 10 out of 10.
Keep it up, Master. This is all thanks to my training.
Well, he can't enter the labyrinth with us, because we didn't share he doesn't even have a 4K either, so
all
I mean.
Alright, let's keep going and solve the remaining locked rooms.
Not part of the core lessons. Alright, now I just have to pick between 2 and 3. And they're both ones that I'm still a little bit unsure about. Screw it, I'll just go in order at this point. In order of how we investigated
the second locked room mystery occurred 3 months ago in that mansion.
Okay.
The corpse was inside the study, and the room's key was found underneath the corpse.
Yeah, this is okay.
If you think you're up for it, then
the fish babies. They're chilling as I play the game. Solution key obtained while investigating cases. It is materialized from the clues of the case. And okay, all right. And we drop in.
There are dolls nailed across the room.
Mm-hmm.
The victim is nailed.
Oh, yes, I swear, if you don't just stay connected.
And the culprit was also missing from this room?
Indeed.
It shares common traits with the other mailman killings.
And we're trapped again. Looks like you gotta solve the mystery of this locked room, or we're not leaving.
Mm-hmm.
I'll try.
Alright, let's see, this is where they escaped from. Now, with this one, when I'm thinking back to it, right?
The door was locked when the corpse was found.
Hmm.
And the only key was underneath the body.
This is true.
There are no windows that could have been used to escape. And the vent is too small to fit through. So how did the culprit escape from here?
I feel like... So as we're looking around, right? I feel like... They said there wasn't like a secret passageway through this or anything like that. Nothing to do with the projector, nothing hidden here. The only logical place they could have went through is the door. That's it.
Here.
Now, how they went about it,
this has to be the spot.
That I gotta figure out.
To leave the room, the culprit had to have taken this door to the hallway.
Okay.
Huh? There's nothing special about that.
They could make it special, you know, jazz it up a little bit. I don't care, you should have popped it. They were like, blam.
But there's no other possibility. There isn't another entrance or exit.
Solve a case with them. I think it'd be fun. There is a DLC, like when I got the game already, they already had like a DLC for him. So wait, if you got the guess wrong of how the culprit escaped, would Loudgrass pop out of the intended door? No, I would take damage. I don't think he would show up. I think he shows up when I'm getting too close to the truth.
But the door itself was locked and the key was found under the corpse, right?
Like, I know in the past
outside in the hallway, how did the culprit
or,
enter
yeah,
the room
like
and
the,
put
the
key
labyrinth
under the
still,
corpse?
Like, it's like, haha.
Try it. Everything must be verified.
Okay. Alright, so we'll take the key.
Sure.
Step outside.
After committing the crime, the culprit went out to the hallway with the key in hand. They then locked the door.
Okay.
Assuming that's the only way to create this locked room, the problem is...
What are you going to do with that key in your hand, Master?
Problem is...
Don't tell me you still have no idea.
I'm working on it, dang it.
Hold on, let me think this over. We should go back inside for now.
Hmm. Oh, goddammit.
What? Huh?
Hi-ya.
Looks like we're locked out.
Why? Well, there's a chair. Break the door down, you know?
This is
like...
This is bad, Master! You better hurry or go fall into the
abyss! Okay.
What do I do?
I mean, I think the key would be small enough to fit through the vent. Just yeet that shiz in there, you know?
Calm down. You just need to solve the mystery. Doing that will open the path.
Easier said than done, ma'am.
You can do
more.
It, can't you?
Maybe. I can do it. I need to be confident.
Try.
I feel like Yuma's non-confidence is rubbing off on me. I can have a big brain moment.
We have to put the key back in the locked room, right? In that case...
Mm-hmm. Because of the culprit. Wait, because of the culprit, what happens to the key? Wait. Let's throw it in.
That's right. The key could be slid through the gap in the vent cover above the door. And if they manage to throw
the key right under the door, the chair like that. But it's still not underneath the body. But, okay, well, I mean, I guess that's a part of it.
It stopped. But nothing happened. The door is still closed.
If it was wrong, a trap would have activated. So we're on the right track about the key being thrown in.
Okay.
But there's more to it than that. If you simply threw it in, it'd be impossible to position it under the corpse.
Okay.
I see. So this is the vital clue for this locked room. I'm beginning to understand what happened here.
Alright.
Oh, Lara, have you already solved the trick to this locked room?
I guess so.
You haven't?
Look, listen.
Hey,
I'm crying my gosh darn bed.
And tell us. Or just me. You can whisper it in my ear.
Excuse me? No. If I don't
get
to know, you don't get to know.
From me, you'll have to pay a fitting price in Xian. Of course, I don't work for cheap.
Oh my gosh.
You really are a devil. Trying to take money from a death god, huh?
The key was definitely tossed inside. But that doesn't explain how it got under the corpse. So, how did the culprit pull off that trick after tossing the key in? Maybe the corpse was moved? That would explain how it was on top of the key. But I had a locked room.
Jesus Christ! Okay. The vibrating in the controller scared me.
Aww, the way's completely blocked off.
But the only things here that can block our progress are mysteries, right?
Right.
That's true! So, we just need to solve the mystery.
Okay.
At least give me a heads up first.
No.
It says, how was...
I've been trying to figure it out for a while, but...
I think I get it.
Evidence was left at the scene.
I think I get it.
Huh?
If you look at the evidence, you'll understand what tool the culprit used to pull this
off. They used the string. And they probably... device some way to, I guess, prop it up in a way. And the only way they were able to prop it up is because the top half wasn't nailed to the floor. Which is why the blood bled vertically instead of sideways.
Tool?
That's all the advice I'll provide. You must figure out the
Halar,
rest yourself.
Are you proud of me? I think I get it.
Got it?
You just want the mystery solved for you, huh? I can tell, because I'm your mentor. So, I'll help you out. Are you ready?
Huh?
Alright, let's do this.
Lay it all out, master!
Let's do it! Oh gosh, not this. Remember the last mystery labyrinth I struggled with this dumb feral thing? But... here's hoping I'm able to do it correctly this time. Like, I think I get the gist of how it went down. Now I just have to figure out the correct word for this. The correct word. So that's broken. The culprit used... yeah. And then... victim's... yeah, the victim's neck. So we'll put that. That's a good key. Yup, so, okay, wait, yo, if you don't slow down with the spinning. S. T. R. I. Give me the I. Got it. In. Give me that G. Give me the G. Oh, I got it. I still got it somehow. Alright. The culprit used a string. Alright, and then just, alright. Love shouty beam. Let's go. Let's go. Bada bing, bada boom.
That's right. there was evidence of a thin string being used at the scene of the crime.
Indeed there was.
A sturdy and thin string like a fishing line must have been used to move the body.
Hmm. Oh gosh, here it goes again.
You really think a tiny string could move a whole corpse?
I believe so.
There he is again! That rude and gloomy guy!
Not the rude and gloomy.
That deduction is wrong. You're wrong.
Your face is wrong. How about that?
I could be wrong about it. Master sounded really confident just now.
Listen. The nails in that corpse's leg pierced through his body. And
in the leg, but not the upper torso. Get beat.
Which means
not paying attention.
The corpse was fixed in place. So,
oh,
nope.
True. If the corpse is stuck in place, it would be impossible to move it.
Indeed. It would be impossible.
But it's possible because it wasn't.
Alara, you think so too?
Oh my god, Yuma.
So I was wrong the whole time?
Yuma! Alright, we'll see. What we got? Oh gosh, what is... Alara! Wait!
Huh? The door!
Okay.
Of course it is.
So that means that his assessment and thinking is wrong. Therefore, you're right in your assessment of being right. Or, okay, I worded that very wrongly, but you know.
You people will never reach the truth.
Watch me.
Master, let's take him down first.
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, what you got for me? What are we doing? I don't think this is another deathmatch, maybe? What are we doing? Okay, another deathmatch, okay. Alright, what key you got me? Got me with. Oh, two keys. Okay, wait.
Your deduction is wrong.
Okay, if we're trying to prove that the corpse was moved, I feel like it just dolls me with resin, not porcelain. It looks like the thin string rubbed against the inner corner of the eye. I feel like that's what's solving a different what's in the corpse. The blood from the nails driven into the upper and lower body are flowing in different directions. The blood stain would not look like this if the corpse was lying face up. This is the correct key.
Do you have any proof that the corpse was moved? The corpse was fixed in place.
I don't think that's okay.
It didn't move a millimeter.
Nope. Smash.
I'll smash through this mystery. No. There was evidence the body had been moved. Wait.
Okay.
The blood from the lower body flowed naturally outwards, along the body's outline. But blood from the upper body looks like it flowed in a downward direction.
Here we go.
The corpse was motionless on its back.
It's all
there
coming together.
There may be such unusual blood stains. In other words, it's safe to assume the body's position was different from when it was discovered.
Hmm. Bro, the noises. Get out of here. Be gone. Oh, but he didn't poof this time. He didn't go poofy. Okay, so we still have to deal with them. You know, I want to know if the what? Oh, why are there three of them?
What's this?
Ugh, gross! We gotta hurry and get through that door.
You want to know if the what?
Unusual circumstances.
Okay.
It doesn't matter. As long as the corpse was pinned to the floor, it couldn't be moved.
I know.
You can't change the truth.
Because there is only one truth.
Even this didn't work?
Yes, but
am I just wrong about it all?
No, stop second guessing yourself. It had to have been moved somehow, and it involves a string.
No, you're correct. The answer you've reached using the evidence is the truth.
Laura!
There's no doubt a fine string was used in this case. Evidence at the crime scene indicate the corpse was moved.
Okay.
So all that remains is to answer. How was the pin body moved?
Okay.
That bizarre bloodstain holds the clue to all of this.
But do I use that key again?
The bloodstain? If the blood blood stain is the clue for how the body could be moved.
I want more scenes in Deathmatch that use more of the scenery. What do you mean by that?
Master, we gotta chase after the door! It's getting further away!
I'm trying, dang it!
Hey,
Jesus,
wait.
All right. Oh, instead of a cage. Oh, okay.
I won't let you!
Why did you say it like that? Like, I won't let you. Oh, shit. Okay. Oh, shoot. Is this quick time? What position was the corpse in before it was moved? Upper body sitting up. Okay, that's one.
That's right. The corpse was sitting up at first.
Clara would really just be like, all right, let's do this. Like, Clara's such a wound.
That's why only the wounds in the upper half of the body bled straight down.
Okay. All right, what else you got for me? What else? What was used to sit the body upright? It should be a string. A thin string. Why?
The string I mentioned before was thin, but sturdy.
Maybe like a fishing line.
It was all over the room, holding the body's upper half in place. That's the reason only the corpse's neck had marks on it.
Okay. Now, what's your last question for me? What was the corpse lying on? Wait, why was the corpse lying back? The string was retrieved? Maybe? Yes, let's go!
The culprit then retrieved all the string that kept the corpse in place from outside the door.
A string could also go through the vent.
And with nothing to support it, the top half of the corpse fell back to the floor, just like how it was discovered.
Ooh, I think I'm getting it. I'm getting the picture. That way it's propped up, they throw the key back inside, and they retrieve the string through the vent. Let me back in.
It appears this locked room mystery will finally be solved.
Look at me being big brain. Let's go. Now, I tried uploading
When did that happen?
Oh, now we have string. Let's go.
Maybe you're supposed to recreate the locked room.
Now, I tried uploading these to Twitch, and Twitch for some reason won't let me upload
Master,
these.
Master, you know the answer, right? Let's finish this.
Right.
They won't see my big brain moments. I feel like the Twitch community is just like, bro, still me no big brain moment. But it's like, I do. I have big brain moments. I think about things. I have thoughts. Alright, recreate the locked room.
You have to recreate the culprit's locked room mystery.
Okay, so it seems like there's five places I have to go to. Alright, well, I know it involves the doll and the body. Maybe we'll start at the door, because we gotta secure it onto something, right? Can I... the vent, maybe? There you go.
First, a knot was tied through a slit in the vent.
Okay.
After that, the fishing line was drawn away to another location. In terms of sequence, it'd probably be easier to start with things that are fixed in place.
Exactly. Alright, so that's one. Maybe the corpse?
Does this location matter? You're supposed to be searching for where the fishing line went next.
So can we do the doll next?
You said you're looking for something that's fixed in place.
I'll fix it. Yeah, so yeah, the doll. Should be the doll. Okay. Oopsie. Took a little damage. It's okay. It's alright. A little damage. It didn't hurt nobody. No, too bad. Not too bad.
That's it. It passed through a doll's eye.
Okay.
And then the fishing line passed through the eye to somewhere else.
Okay. Now where to go? Don't think the lamp will be secure enough. Let's see. Now the corpse?
Right.
Yes,
the
now the corpse.
Was then passed around a certain point on the corpse. That was...
underneath the neck. Under the neck. Which is why there's the line just there.
Here, behind the neck. The line ends here to support it. Now, it's clear that the line passed through the vent, the doll's eye, and ended beneath the neck.
Okay.
Hang on. Why pull a line through the doll first? Can't you just start by pulling it from under the body?
No.
To support the body's weight, the lie needs to pass through the doll first, as it was fixed in place.
Okay.
Next, the fishing line.
Okay. I feel like that would, in order to get that sharp cut, or that sharp angle that it has, maybe back to the door?
Now, to return the line to the-
Let's go, smart!
This kept the corpse's upper torso in place.
Let's go.
The room has been completely prepared.
So next, we leave. We sew it in.
The culprit exited through the door and locked it with the key.
Smart. Surprised the doll head didn't follow the wall? Oh, follow to the wall. What do you mean? The vent cap.
The key was thrown through the gap in the vent.
Okay.
If the culprit managed to drop the key next to the corpse, the only thing left was to untie the line. Then...
Okay. And it falls, and it covers it.
Which was supported only by the line, would fall face up on top of the key. That's how the culprit created the locked room.
And then you can just retrieve the string from right from the vent, from the get. Let's go.
Hey, you did it! That's my
locked room complete. Let's go. Now there's just the last case, which is probably the hardest to solve. But it's also like it's a little bit different than the others.
The bloodstains were strange. The length of the nails driven into the upper and lower body were different.
Mm-hmm.
The nails on the upper half didn't penetrate all the way through the body. But the nails on the lower half went all the way through and into the floor.
To make sure it's definitely secure, probably.
That was how the lower half could be secured, while the upper half could still be moved around.
Let's go.
Sure was tricky, but you managed to solve the mystery behind it.
Sorry, looking at my fish again. Give me that key. Give me that treasure.
Looks like we finally made it to the treasure chest.
Mm-hmm.
Speaking of, don't you think that whoever worked the hardest should get to open it?
Me.
Witches. Me, of course.
Okay, machine got me. I'll let it slide, because it's kind of on my model. It's okay. It's alright. I'll let it slide. Alright, so there's that key.
This is probably another clue leading to the culprit. I'm not sure how we use it.
Okay.
Still, it must be used for something. Hold on to it.
Alright, so now we're off to the last one.
Let's
solve the doll's flying around. Not gonna lie, it do be a little creepy.
Right.
You know, the treasure being key is ironic in a way. It's like you figure you need a key to open a treasure chest, I'm guessing.
The third locked room was a murder that happened 1 month ago in the art gallery storage in Gima District.
Okay.
Pictures and paint were scattered all around the spot where a woman was boom killed.
Freaking boom killed.
If you think you're up for it, then let's solve this thing.
Let's do it.
Are you going to the third locked room?
I am.
Yeah.
Alright. Drop it in. I think we could do this. I think it can be done. You better treasure you can't get. Wait. Get in. Get in, because the key inside.
Did we get
I'm getting
stuck
hungry.
Inside a locked room again?
Oh my gosh, Shinigami,
this was the corpse that was discovered by that worshipper and the art gallery employee.
Well, all of them were technically discovered by the worshipper.
At the time of discovery, the door was locked and the key was nailed to a doll inside the room.
Mm-hmm.
Aside from the door, the only other entrance is the window, but...
You can't fit a human being through that. Ain't no way in the world.
It opens just enough to fit a finger in. The frame itself is too small for even a child to squeeze through.
Yeah, no.
How did the culprit vanish from here?
Slice and dice? Again, I think this is another door situation. Where they went directly through the door. Now we just gotta figure out how they went about. Bro, they went through the-
I think the culprit could have only escaped from here, but...
What? Shins, if you got locked inside the room, not one, two, but three times, I'm sure it's locked again. Exactly. Like, sometimes I'm just like... Sometimes, especially, like, it's not even just Shinigami with, like, the repetitive of, like, oh my gosh, another locked room. Oh no, we're locked inside. What are we gonna do? But also sometimes just stating the obvious. Like, when we went to the clock tower, just like, so this is the crime scene. I'm gonna describe exactly what we're looking at. Like, alright.
Nothing's happening. Maybe you made a mistake, Master.
No.
No, that can't be right. It's impossible for anyone to squeeze through that window. They could have only gotten out through the door. I'm sure the culprit had the key and locked the door from the outside after committing the crime.
So they had to put the key back inside. Let's just do the window. Cause you can't fit the person, but you can fit a key in there.
The culprit just used a copy of the key. Would that really be considered a locked room mystery?
No, it would not.
Well, there are only two keys to the storage space, and the design makes them impossible to duplicate. I learned that thanks to you, Alara.
One of the keys is always carried by that one employee. It was used when the body was first discovered,
exactly,
right?
Exactly, so they had to have had it, which means they.
And the only other key was nailed through a doll onto a painting.
Mm-hmm.
So, it is a locked room mystery! Right? Oh, that's totally it.
Ma'am, calm down.
I suppose you could call it that. Hey, Yuma, can you go check outside of that window?
Alright, this is the same thing Halara wanted to do, and so it has to be something with the window.
Oh, just like before.
Before?
Halara's shocked face is like, precious. I love it.
Yeah, you made me do the same thing in the real world when we were investigating this place.
I see. Then the answer has already been confirmed. Very well. This locked room is solved.
Huh? Wait. Did you already solve this mystery?
Watch Halara say, did you not?
You haven't?
Oh my gosh.
How about you go and check outside the window? Then
okay.
Even...
Oh, oops.
Oh, it unlocked. Looks like you can go outside.
All right,
let's go see.
All right, let's go. I'm hungry. I know once this case is over, I'm
gonna
probably.
Didn't you already check this in the real world?
Finally.
Why do it again?
Halara told me to check it twice.
So you just do
there
as you're told, I guess.
There must be an important clue outside that window.
Hey, maybe the culprit threw the key in through the window.
No.
That way, the key would be found inside.
But it has to be on the doll.
Well, how about that theory?
No. Okay, now we have the key.
Is this the storage key?
No, it's the key to my freaking garden shed. What do you think it is?
Which means... Whee!
Because of the culprit, what happened to the key?
This one's a freebie! I was right! Just toss it in there, Master!
No, I don't, at this point, I've learned to never truly trust what Shinigami says, because it's usually always wrong. And I feel like that's gonna bite me at some point in the future, but for right now, I'm going to trust that logic of not trusting
it. Did the key inside? Is that really the right answer? Did the culprit throw the key in from the window?
No.
Master,
no.
Hurry up and throw the key!
No. I don't wanna. I'm not gonna do it.
Your footing's crumbling away! You're gonna fall!
I'm gonna be defiant. If I fall, I fall. It'll be my own fault then. Well, would you look at that?
That's the right answer?
Congratulations, you was the key to the city!
How? Didn't the culprit throw the key in there?
No, because
that's why the key was found inside,
nailed
right?
Nailed to the doll, you freaking dingus.
No, the crime scene wouldn't end up like that if we threw it in. The key was nailed to a painting. That's not possible if you just throw it into the room.
Oh, right. But if the culprit didn't throw it in there, how is the key left in the room?
That's the question.
If you can't nail the key after throwing it...
Shit. Bro, don't play football. Come on! Are you serious? Oh, okay.
You're back.
Wait, but the painting and doll's gone.
The key vanished.
The key is in my hand.
Oh, and there's the doll.
Master, you got the doll and nail!
Okay.
I see. So you're supposed to recreate the locked room in the same way the culprit did.
How would you
try
know
it out?
About it?
Doing so will create a new path.
Okay.
Yeah.
If
I'm gonna solve
so.
This.
Gosh, I'm hungry.
Good luck, Master!
Recreate the locked room.
You have to recreate the culprit's locked room mystery. First, do something about that doll.
Okay. Alright, so... Okay, there's the paint. Okay. I'm gonna nail the doll to the painting.
The culprit nailed the doll onto the painting.
Okay, so there's that.
Next, both were stood up at a certain location.
So you prop it against the wall. I get it now! I get it! Oh, okay. Put it, wait. Come here. I get it. And from that angle,
facing the window, now the part with the pierced doll is right next to the window. After that,
you go back outside. You go outside.
Then the culprit went outside.
Look at me!
The door was locked, and they went to the other side of the storage room.
Okay, you lock it, then you go back outside. And then...
I can see the painting and doll through the
and
window.
And that's why it was done
but
there.
I can barely fit my
open
hand
it
through the cap.
Let's go.
The doll's got a nail in it, but the problem is that key in your hand, Master.
So you take another nail, and you
Yeah, the culprit took the key and then...
Nailed it to the doll. There's the window, nailed to the painting with the doll, and the nail... No, so yeah, you had to nail it.
The culprit nailed the key to the painting, along with the doll from outside the window.
Let's go.
Finally...
And you just push it. Push it real good.
I pushed the painting into the room.
Bam.
It completes the locked room mystery.
Let's go.
This is
Oops. Alright. So that's that. All the rooms are solved.
It took some time, but you've reached the truth behind this locked room.
Throwing the key through the window would be obvious. So to mislead us into thinking that was impossible, the key was nailed to a painting which was then pushed over.
It's one thing for an amateur, but a detective wouldn't be tricked by this.
What do you mean by that, Poco? What are you on about? I'm confused.
Seriously, only amateurs would get fooled by...
You got fooled by Shinigami. You're an
Wait,
amateur.
You mean me?
Yes. Wee! Give me that chest. Oh, green man. Oh.
Hey, a treasure chest!
Yeah, he didn't appear. Yeah, no, he didn't.
Who's gonna open open this one.
Yeah, it's too easy.
The meanest one of us open it.
How would you decide that?
Like this.
Okay, Shinigami thinks that she's mean. All right.
I'm the meanest. Let's check out this treasure.
Huh? What's wrong?
Is there nothing in there?
It's empty.
Bro, what the?
Huh? Why? After all we went through to solve this locked room.
I guess maybe that's why he didn't appear. Maybe he took the key. He's like, bet, I'll let you solve it, but you can go and get a key for it.
This must mean solving the third locked room mystery doesn't necessarily bring us any closer to the ultimate truth.
Okay.
That's terrible. I suddenly feel so tired.
Bro, you better not go to sleep.
We can't call it quits. We gotta keep going.
Okay. But if... So then... I don't get it then.
That's it for all the locked rooms.
A sneak.
We make a pretty good team. Don't you think so?
Well, what do we do from here?
I don't know. Okay, close the curtains. Oh, okay. Oh, new path.
See. The way forward is clear. It must be due to solving all of the locked room mysteries. Now let's go.
Right.
Alright.
Again, I gotta ask. Who's supposed to be the protagonist here?
It's Yuma, dang it. It's Mr. Coco Head. I'm hungry. I wanna snack. Or something.
This
I actually
place
need to eat
is
dinner.
Don't be afraid to roll the dice. You must keep pursuing the truth.
Bro, what type of dungeon is this?
Emotions
place?
Must be discarded to reach
a perfect
solution.
Feels
through
they,
a perfect
the main
deduction. Isn't that right?
I mean, they're part of it, you know?
Yes.
They're part of the leading. They're a piece of the puzzle, you know? That completes the late lead protagonist. You wouldn't even be here without her, so I mean, you know? What is this?
Is this some dungeon?
What
looks
is
like
the
it.
Meaning of this?
What is the meaning of this?
Here.
Why does he say it like that? Oh
out.
My god, his eyes are open.
I'll kill your ass in the name of God!
God, I love her. Anyway.
I have nothing to do with the...
So now we must pick out the true culprit of this case.
I still think it's
the
priest.
True culprit.
Yuma.
He was talking about
all
like
the locked room mysteries before you made it here.
He's talking about, oh, it's because of salvation and stuff. Nah, man, that's some real shady stuff to say.
You should have all the clues and evidence you need to accuse the culprit. To be honest, when I first met you, I thought you were rather pitiful.
Wow, okay. So it wouldn't be wrong that Shinigami's supporting character. No, it wouldn't be wrong.
But my opinion.
But
they're big
support.
These mysteries have brought you closer to becoming a true detective.
Aw, thanks, Halara.
Now tie up all the loose ends. And
catch me, but put it towards us, oh Halara.
Alright, I'll try.
Okay.
Okay.
Who was the man?
The nail man?
Okay.
I'm not the culprit.
Okay.
I'm not the nail man.
Okay. How can I be the nail man?
I'm not the nail man. I'm not the culprit.
I'm not the nail man.
Why anybody else saying nail man? You saying culprit. Get out of here.
Culprit?
I still think it's you. Get sliced. I bet you was the priest. I bet you.
The culprit is you, Father.
What? That's an absolutely...
Oh, excuse me, Rainbow Roseberry Bush. You ain't have to be here. Ain't nobody call for you.
Ridiculous.
What are you doing here?
Ridiculous thing to say.
See, nah.
Him again? Why won't he just give up?
I'm telling you, they're in cahoots with the church, and that's why they're trying to cover it up, because they know it's the priest.
You're saying the priest, a man of the cloth, is the culprit?
He wasn't even, he hasn't even been a priest
impossible.
For that long.
How dare
if I remember
you
correctly.
Such nonsense.
Right! Do not make baseless accusations.
It's not baseless.
The culprit has to be someone else.
It just has to be.
Yuma, can I leave this to you?
It's not a baseless accusation. You're the only one who could possibly be the culprit.
Master, you're acting like a real detective.
I am a real detective, dang it.
Boom, kill him.
Green man, go away. You need to put that elsewhere. Oh my god, okay, that's a funky look. Alright, now what are we doing? Wait, two at once! Wait, that I can't do that! Wait! I mean, no, I can't. No, I need to be confident. I can do it. I can. I believe in myself. Kind of, maybe. Yes, I do. Person with access to the incinerator. Yeah, I can do this. Okay? You can be a man of many things. Party? I am doubting you.
This total blasphemy! I am not the nail.
Oh god! Oh god! Okay, good job! Oh god! Ah! Okay, alright, hold on. Stop. Okay, duck.
The mailman is the worshiper.
I think not. Slice it.
This is the truth.
Stole the yoga. Oh my god. Okay.
The rope ladder used in the clock tower's locked room was found in the incinerator, which only clergy can access.
Let's go.
The worshiper may be a regular churchgoer. But he's no clergy member.
I paid attention to that.
So he's no longer a
suspect.
Shut up! Shut up!
Dang, you tell him to shut up!
Ridiculous!
Alright, what else you throwing at me? Bird rope remains thin person.
A member of the church is the culprit?
Okay.
Even so, I am not the culprit.
Rope remains, but we already kind of technically used that. Person, only someone with a slender build. So if we're talking about members of the church, he's gonna start throwing at other people. So I'm gonna go with this.
Culprit.
Jump.
There are others working for the church.
Okay.
Yes, there's the servant. The servant must be the nailman.
No.
The servant was able to commit the crimes.
No, I was in the wrong place! Dang it! No!
He pretended to discover a rope ladder.
Nope. So it has to be that other, okay. I have to go through it again.
Right.
Can we speed? Alright, speed. Let's go.
A member of the church is the culprit? Even so, I am not the culprit.
Okay. Jump.
There are others working for the church.
Come on, my way.
Yes,
that.
There's the servant. The servant must be the nailman.
Duck.
The servant was able to commit the crimes.
Coming? Let's go.
Let's do this mystery.
Get out of here where all that noise.
Climbing up to the underground casino's window with only nails for footing would require considerable agility.
He's proven that he doesn't have. He just said so himself.
There's no way someone of his size could have committed the crime.
Oh, no, no!
Yes.
Absolute lies!
Bro. Okay. Alright.
Enough!
What do we have here? Floor plan to study. Alright, absolutely.
It's not like she's afraid of heights.
Dodge that.
She used the nails to climb.
Are ducking? Duck.
And you know she's always saying.
You know she's always
I'll
saying.
Kill your ass in the name of God.
Why you say it like that though?
It's clear she's the ruthless soul.
Slice. Alright, what are we doing? What's the thought? Norman has to be a member of the clergy and thin. If that's all, doesn't the nun also fit the bill?
What?
She's not the nail man, though. I can prove it.
The nun must be!
Key's placement requires only some of full use of their arm! Oh! Okay. Yes, okay. But what do I hit back? That's the question.
She's thin! Absolutely able to commit the crimes.
No! Bam! Let's go! Okay. Okay.
The mansion study's locked room. The culprit tossed the key behind the corpse with perfect aim.
And her dominant hand is injured. Let's go.
With her dominant hand injured, the nun couldn't have done that. Which means she's not the culprit.
Oh, you feel defeated now? Just give up. Just give us your soul. It's okay. You done did what you did. It's all right.
It's not the churchgoer, right? The servant, or the nun. There's only one option.
My thing is this, right? So, like, if we don't technically now, if we stay at this point, right, and see if we use the quote unquote emergency escape, couldn't we then, with what we know now, but see if the, you know what? Hold on, reverses. I don't know. I guess because, like, in order to, like, solve the case and not have anyone die, but then if it doesn't fully disappear yet, I guess it's not fully solved.
Father, it's you. You are the nail man.
Say something quick. Otherwise, they'll pin me as the culprit.
Because you did it. You goofy looking, cotton candy growing turnip head. I don't know. I ran out.
You're useless.
Oh.
I am a priest in service to God.
Oh God. Okay, that's a transformation.
I am not the nail man.
But you know, you got a bunch of nails on your body, so I think otherwise, you know. Dear Lord.
All your proof is nothing but fantasy. You don't have a single piece of hard evidence.
Hard evidence?
But Master, you do. It's easy.
Okay.
Based on the facts, the priest must be the culprit. The decisive evidence that proves it is. I don't know. What do I do?
Bro, don't panic. If you panic, I start panicking, please.
A detective must always prioritize solving a case. Listen, a detective isn't an arbiter of justice. Unraveling a case is top priority, even with questionable methods.
Oh, so we about to lie to this man. Let's
lie. What do you mean? In short, you must get them to confess. Use everything in your arsenal, even if it requires bluffing.
Let's go.
Use everything?
Don't hesitate to use anything that might give you an advantage.
Okay.
Emotions must be discarded to reach a perfect solution through a perfect deduction. Always remember that.
Bluff. In other words, I should just claim I have solid evidence.
But what evidence do I
but
use?
But what could I use as a bluff?
Oh, now he's stomping. Oh, you have an old temper tantrum there, buddy? Alright, what keys are you giving me? Oh, the music in this game goes hard, though. Okay. Oh gosh, okay. Murder case reports suspicious footprints and mailman. Wait. Past mailman murders. It's not. Suspicious footprints in grassy areas on the clock tower. Apparently, they may be made by dress shoes. There's nothing court concerning the clock tower murder case. But that has nothing concrete either. What can I use to bluff? I think these two are set in stone. The footprints. Footprints is in the loafers. Man, priest must be a muscle birder to God Scrawny, bruh. I don't know. I wanna see what the
lines are. Enough with your stupid fantasies.
I wanna try and like, oh god, okay, hey. Slow down. Slow down! Stop! Oh my god, which way is it going? No! Whoa!
Did you find my fingerprints? Did you find my blood? Because I'm not the culprit!
Jump.
That's true.
Unless he sees himself like that, then ooh, he'd be edgy.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm so sorry. Use whatever you have, bluff if you have to. Footprints. I don't know. Wait. Let me switch my stuff up.
Everything.
Jump.
There's nothing but a fantasy. Do you have any proof that I'm a culprit? Did you find my fingerprints?
Wait. Slice. Oh, was that it? Not it? Wait, what? I don't think we found any fingerprints during the investigation. What about those footprints? But I thought I did get the footprints. Well, maybe you could use them? And since it's evidence the criminal left behind, they'd be able to use it. So it is the footprint, but I'm just not slashing the right thing. Oh, whoa.
Everything you say.
Jump.
Is nothing but a fantasy.
It's going that way.
Do you have any proof that I'm a culprit?
Dodge. Okay, it's going that
Did
way.
Did you find my blood? Of course there's no evidence.
Slice? Yes, it's gold. Okay.
You left clear evidence at the clock tower's crime scene.
Okay.
There were footprints left under the window in the mud. When we inspected them, we found out they perfectly match your footprints.
Let's go.
Impossible. I already burned those shoes in the incinerator.
Well, you just outed yourself.
You gave yourself away.
You look foolish. With your logical thinking and as well as your denying. You just look foolish. You're a fool.
I swear, I only enacted justice.
No, you did not, sir.
Looks like it worked. Good job, Yuma.
Oh, good job.
Thanks.
Kanai War is rotten to the core. Those slain were the evil incarnate that harmed others. That's why the people asked the nailmen to kill them.
Trying to be God, though.
Evil must be punished. And so, I strangled them. Made them suffer. All I did was slay.
Bro placed his hand on his head like he was confused. Oh, okay. Wait, bye-bye. Ooh.
If someone hates somebody bad enough, they give that name to the nail man.
Shinigami, I swear, here you go again, stating the gosh diggity darn obvious.
And this priest went around killing those people as the nail man.
No shit, Sherlock.
The urban legend offered targets for murder.
A priest is supposed to be the voice of God. But he went around killing people because someone wanted them dead.
What is awesome?
It's terrible. It's insane to think that he'd kill people for a reason like that. That could be said about all murders. Insane people kill for insane reasons. Anyway, you did it, Yuma. My expectations of you weren't wrong after all. Is it finally over? Huh, nothing's happening. But last time...
Yeah, the soul of the true culprit who created this mystery labyrinth should appear.
Gosh, is there more?
And since it didn't, it looks like this isn't over yet.
Gosh darn it.
Huh? It's not over?
There are still mysteries related to the Nailman killings within this mystery labyrinth.
But we solved all of the locked rooms and discovered the true identity of...
Hungry!
But the priest even confessed
Let
to it!
Let me eat, Mystery Labyrinth, please! For I should not stop stream until I've been in this labyrinth.
Calm down, Yuma. There's no need to panic. If the Nailman's identity is exposed and all mysteries are yet to be solved, then most likely someone else's agenda is involved in this string of killings.
Okay.
Someone else's agenda?
Meaning the Nailman didn't work alone.
So he had to work with Amaterasu.
You mean...
So, like, because obviously they're trying to cover it up.
Yuma, if you consider yourself to be a detective, you must see the truth through to the very end. No mystery concludes with a dead end. There is nothing we detectives cannot solve.
Oh, Lara. I love it.
All right.
We have to review these killings from a different perspective.
Okay. And that perspective being? Where are you taking me? Where are we going now?
Out of the four locked rooms, if any of them are hiding a mysterious secret, it would be the room that's obviously different from the others.
Which would have to be three.
Different?
Master, I get the feeling you want my help.
No, I don't. Isn't I know which room it is. Just let me go.
Huh?
No, stop.
Fine. I can't say no to you, and you're so help.
It's three. But what, do I still have to go to the barrel? It's Gibb, and that's one of the mini names of Danganronpa that I never liked. Not saying I never liked, but it's just, it always had difficulty with it. Wait, this locked room is different because of the victims, what?
You can do it, Master!
I don't know, the victims, is it, wait, should it be death?
Go,
yep,
go.
It's death. Where's the E? Can you slow down?
That's right.
T, give me the T!
Right.
Where's the H, where's the H?
Right.
Death, let's go. You know that loose hair, wait, you know that loose hair got the shape, question mark. Oh yeah, on Yuma's head? Yeah. Cause he's just questioning life, he just doesn't know what the heck is going on. Yeah, on Yuma. I'm just questioning life. Bam! Oh, another path. Let's go.
A new path's opened up. It seems to be a hidden passage. If so, then the truth should be somewhere down there. Let's go.
He got me cute. She do be kind of cute. She do be kind of a baddie. Yeah, got so many questions. I mean, considering he also has amnesia.
So the cause of death for the victim at the art gallery storage is the only one that's different.
Because he had the head trauma, blunt force trauma.
Right. The victims in the other locked rooms were all strangled to death. All had strangulation marks and scratches.
See, even the peacekeepers couldn't even pick that up. Like, come on.
The third locked room had strangulation marks, but no signs of resistance.
From Zelda Twilight Princess.
There's also evidence of blunt traumas of the head.
I'm not a fan of Zelda, but I'm not too knowledgeable on it. Like, Tears of the Kingdom is the first ever Zelda game that I've played. You're also talking about Legend of Zelda, right? I think, maybe.
The marks could have been made after the victim died, so as to appear as if strangulation was the cause of death.
I played every Zelda game so far. I didn't have access to, like, all of it. Zelda, yes, it's one of my favorite games. Okay. Like, the name sounds, like, familiar, like, I feel like I have heard it before. But putting, like, the story to it. Like, some of the Zelda games, I at least know, like, the story or the premise of it. Okay.
Here's another obstacle. But it's likely to be an insignificant one. Yuma, let's solve this mystery and move on.
Oh, Halara.
Right.
Oh gosh, here we go again. Slice and dice. Why was the cause of death made to look like strangulation? The work of the priest, coincidence. Usually for a copy. I swear to gosh, to be darned, it's also, you know what? That's what I'm picking. And I bet you it's right. So wait, is this a 2-for-1 special? What did it be?
The three incidents. By making the crime scene as similar as possible, it appeared like the mailman was responsible for an unrelated murder.
And it's only one person that could have also known about the strangulation.
This was a copycat crime.
Because that part wasn't publicized. Alright, come here, sir. I'm grabbing you. You're getting nabbed. Why is the little boy here? Wait, what?
Among the string of mailman killings, there could be some that were done by copycat criminals.
Has to be why the mystery labyrinth still remains, even after discovering the mailman's identity. So who is the copycat criminal?
Indeed. We need to uncover this and...
Alright.
I'm sorry if I'm, like, also clicking through because, like I said, I'm hungry. Who's the copycat killer?
You're accusing me of being the copycat criminal? What the hell? I'll kill your ass!
I love her so much! Bro, it's obviously the little boy. He just doesn't even say anything. He's like, bro, if you make this choice, you're stupid. Oh, he's crying. Oh, no.
No, it's not me.
I told you already. I have nothing to do with this.
I say it's you, Mr. Smokes a Lot. That man smokes every hour. Like, how are you not?
You are the copycat criminal.
He's the only one who could have access to that information.
Told you all about the nail man, and even cooperated with your investigation.
Cause you're freaking obsessed with it.
And now you think I'm
gonna be
a
part of it?
Are you fucking kidding me?
Oh my. Okay, we got a mouse on here.
Your investigation isn't worth shit.
Oh, he's got a mouse. Oh God.
You to dust, you filth!
Ooh, they did you dirty. It's even worse than the priest. What he looks like the thing is though too, I remember when we were like first doing the investigation and stuff, and I was like, what if that's his, like, his son or something like that, and what if he's the one that's actually doing the murder? That's why he's so obsessed with the mailman, because I thought he was a suspect too, but the priest was just also just yelling at me. Oh gosh. Okay, hold on.
Why are you
what keys are you? Past mailman murders, victim's neck, non-public information. Bro, if the boy came in, this is a mastermind. Bro. Like I love the fact that he didn't even say anything. He's just like, bro. It's just like, if you make this choice, like, what's wrong with you? I was just first on the scene.
Why do you think I'm a copycat criminal?
Up again.
It could have all been the nail man.
It could have. Should have. But no.
It's just different each time, yeah?
No. Wait. Wait, the victims of serial killings. Wait. I think that's what I might have to make that made that joke right. No! So I think this might be the one I had to hit that one.
Even if there was a copycat.
Let me just listen out to what else he says.
Why is it me? The survey could be the copycat!
No. Whoa. Oh shoot, I just dived right into that cat. Darn it. Okay.
Anyone could have done it!
Duck, duck, duck. Who's... Alright, I think that's... The normal incident was talking to him, since couldn't anyone be the copycat killer?
Except...
But in order to copy the crime... Were those details widely known? Let's check the solution. No. Okay.
Why accuse me of being the culprit? I was just first on the scene.
Hold on. Wait, no, no, stop. I didn't mean to do that. I did not mean to press that button. Yes, this has to be the right key. I just need to find the right thing to slash it.
Why do you think I'm a copycat criminal? It could have all been the nail man. The cause of death was just different each time, yeah?
No.
Even if there was a copycat criminal, why is it me? The servant could be the copycat.
Whoa.
Could be the copycat.
Whoa, hey!
Anyone could have done it!
I don't think so. Slash! There you go. Come on,
slash through this mystery.
Okay, there we go.
The cause of death in the art gallery was blunt force trauma.
Okay.
Faked as a strangling to resemble the nail man's M.O. But the murders all being strangulations wasn't made public right away.
Exactly.
The only ones who knew that were those who actually set foot on the crime scenes.
Which includes you.
That includes the mailman himself, the peacekeepers, and the first eyewitnesses on the scene. Which means you. You could have committed the murder in the art gallery.
Were you running from the
Master, after him! Beat some sense into that sensitive, nonsensical phantom!
The what?
Alright, let's do this. The closer I get to solving the case, the sooner I can.
For the first on the scene to also be the culprit is rather cliche.
Hello.
He was always suspicious, but because the real mailman was someone else, I didn't connect the dots. He was
so
fascinated by the mailman. And by studying him, he eventually knew more about him than anyone else.
By knowing too much about the other ones.
Master, the truth is right there! My radar is banging like crazy!
Banging?
Banging into the radar. You're a little canceled. You think that's gonna protect you?
I won't let you! You have the truth!
Give me the truth.
Looks
Give
like
it to
we've
me.
Arrived at the final stage.
If we make him submit, we'll completely solve the mystery labyrinth!
What a way to phrase that.
Master, don't let your guard down!
Let's do this. Let's do it. You're in the way of me eating food, sir. You must pay for your crimes. Alright, there she goes. Ominous up. Why does she do everything with her mouth though, bro? Like, what the heck, bro? You have hands for a reason. Alright, God Shinigami. Wait, the worshiper had, Wait, hold on. I can't pause. Can I? Oh, I can't pause, hold on. The worshiper had a higher up. Had a higher up father, or was that the nun? What do you mean? What do you mean by that?
Master.
Okay, why is it tackled?
Damn you! Stop it!
Jump!
Shut up.
Kick!
Damn
Kick!
Stop
Kick!
With your lies.
Tackle! Tackle?
How dare you accuse me when you have no proof?
This right solution key. Holaris Forte.
You're wrong! Huh?
Executive
on.
Parent, what do you mean by that? I'm still confused.
Thanks to Holaris Forte, We were able to see what each crime scene looked like at that time.
I don't get the question.
My power allows me to see the moment the first witness saw the crime scene. Not the culprit, not the victim, but how it appeared when a third party first entered.
We use post-cognition to gather all the evidence.
Time to kill
him! Oh, she really do be booking it. What am I doing? Jump. Wrong leg, bro. What? No. I don't think I will.
Stop it!
Smash.
Get away from me, get away.
No, I don't think I will. Kick.
Get away. Who cares if you use post-cognition? You only saw
Jump.
What I saw as the first person on scene. No clue Jump. Will help lead you to the culprit.
Alright, what we got?
You're
what
never gonna find the culprit. What you saw is only what I saw the moment the corpse was discovered.
Okay. Destroy the forces with the correct solution key. Third person, the thin person, non-public information, archaeology, and painting. Evidence found related to the murder of the archaeologist storage room at the time the body was discovered. Someone from the church tried to enter a room and knocked over a paint can. If he was the one that came, that not so. So, confirm.
Polaris post-cognition showed us that the paint can at the gallery storage entrance.
Man, I'll tell if she got them legs in tough metal. To be kicking yet.
According to the art gallery staff member's testimony, that was your doing.
Exactly.
You
so he
went
was
into
the
crime scene first, and the art gallery employee behind you noticed you knocking over the paint can.
So it's the dude dies.
So if you were the
dies.
First person to find the body, the scene before the paint can fell over would have been recreated.
Exactly.
But it wasn't. The paint can had already been knocked over when the corpse was discovered. That means the first person to find the corpse was the art gallery staff member, not you.
Zed.
The reason you didn't count as the first person to find it is because you're the culprit. This is the truth of the case!
Smash him down! They did so well with Jimmy Bob. I just can't go with that, honestly. Such a good Alright, there we go. Now, this should be the end.
Master, finish him! Shove all your evidence into the solution blade and slash as hard as you can!
Let's do it! Hey look, it's the first thumbnail. The scene for the first thumbnail. Slice and dice. Make it nice. Ah, oh, shoot, I still gotta do this. I forgot about this. Then while this is going, maybe I can get a snack. And also go to the back. So, this should be fairly simple to figure out. Alright, where did the culprit leave to the room? X. The vent. Is that there? Next page. What did the culprit use to climb? Should be the nails, yep. Next page. What did the culprit tie to the vent? Should be the string. What's the next one? What did the culprit pass the lion? Should be the doll. Yeah. Oh, I didn't place it. Okay. See, breezing through. Alright, where's the culprit past the line through last? Should be the door again. Nope, wait, hold on. Or I guess maybe the corpse's neck, I guess. Technically it would be the door again, but I mean, pop off, I guess, is. There we go. Was nailed to the doll, so the key. Yep. Where did the culprit? What did the culprit use to escape? Okay, this is all filled. What did the culprit use to destroy the evidence? It should be the incinerator. Oh god. Okay, who's the nail man? It's the priest. The true nail man. Then who's the nail man's copycat? Which is this robo. Alright, that should be it. Mystery unraveled, let's go.
See, scrapbook all the evidence like a graphic novel.
Yeah, so that, even in the other Danganronpa games, that's usually, even though, like I said, this is not Danganronpa per se, but, yeah, they had a section where they would do that. So this is gonna go on auto, so what I'm gonna do is go get a snack and go to the bathroom while this is running. And it explains all the cases. I'll be back.
Solve the mystery.
P. It's still going. It's still going. Oh my gosh. Or is it not still going? Did my capture card... Oh no, did my capture card stop working? Oh no, where'd my... Oh no, I think my capture card did stop. Oh gosh, diggity darn it. Of course it did. Ay, ay, ay. Of course it did. Where is my thing? Video capture device. Custom. Pixel. Okay, there.
The Nailman is an urban legend of Kanai.
Oh, did it not go on auto?
Write down the name of someone you want.
Oh my gosh.
And drive a nail through it and a doll to a tree behind the church.
I thought it went on auto.
The mailman will kill that person for you with a countless number of nails.
A string of murders exactly
like
the urban legend.
I still have
traps and dolls nailed down within a locked room.
The
first murder happened 6 months ago at a secret club in Kamisaki District.
It is auto! Wait, well, oh, I probably pressed the auto button on my way out. Ish.
I heard the buy-in to place a bet was pretty steep, and cheating was rampant, so it was obviously a scummy place.
I thought about making dinner, but then I was like,
the key to the door was inside of the glass. And the vent that connects outside looked too high for escape to be possible.
The culprit used the nails driven into the wall as footholds to climb. Why, the nails that were bent downward.
The vent was not screwed down at the time of the murder. So it could easily be removed and used as an escape route. The second murder happened 3 months ago. It was at a mansion near Ginma District.
The victim was some real estate agent who lived there. And the cause of death was again strangulation. He made a lot of money through shady real estate deals, so of course someone would be out to get it.
Coca.
The door to the crime scene was the only possible entrance. But the key to that door was underneath the nailed down victim. After the culprit escaped, some sort of trick was used to get the key back into the room.
The fisherman passed from the vent through the eye socket of the doll and propped up the upper body of the corpse. All that was left was to exit the room, lock it, throw the key in from the vent, and boom! You've got yourself a locked room mystery!
The key was tossed under the victim from the vent.
Right.
Once the fishing line was retrieved, the corpse's upper body fell over, completing the crime scene.
The nails on the upper body didn't pierce through completely. So it wasn't nailed down at all.
The third murder happened one month ago in an art gallery storage room in Ginma District.
The spirit's child of death was a pretty lady who let her looks get to her head, and she got bone killed.
The key to the storage room was nailed to a painting through a doll. Another trick was used to get the key back inside the room here.
The painting with the doll nailed to it was propped up against the window, and then the culprit left the room. They nailed the key to the painting through the window, knocked it over, and bam! All done!
Those are the truths behind the past three cases. And now, there's been another murder at the clock tower in Kanai.
Oh my god.
Woman's cause of death was strangulation.
Also, pay no mind to tell my
Since
mom.
Since you told that kid you'd take care of it, you've got to solve this case.
The clock tower crime scene is rather high up on the third floor. The door was locked from the inside, and the window shutters were also locked. But there was rainwater under the window, and the nails in two of the dolls had rug marks.
In other words, the culprit must have hung a rope ladder from the dolls to escape out the window. With my logic, anything is possible.
Why are you imitating Hilara?
I'm about to say, that does not sound like Hilara's voice actor. I was like, no way.
The killer cut their footing on the way down from the window. That way, they could just pull on one side of the rope to retrieve the whole thing.
The shutters come down under their own weight, so they locked once the rope was collected. I'm surprised you noticed the auto-locking feature. You sure love your shutters, Master!
The rope ladder was collected.
Those shutters may be nice.
Then burned in the church incinerator, which only clergy have access to.
That's how we know the mailman must be someone from the clergy.
It's all coming together.
But one question arose from this. Mailman killing share one more characteristic. All the victims were murdered by strangulation. This piece of information wasn't publicized.
See, that's where you messed up.
Marks were added later.
Which means that it was someone mimicking the mailman. But I already know the identity of the copycat killer. First, the mailman must be someone thin enough to pass through the vent.
Someone with the skills to build a human.
The council was trying to go to sleep over there.
Some affiliated with the church.
EU.
The priest! You're the nail man!
EU! He just, like, even the way to design him, he just designed looks suspicious. And then this dude just trying to be an all-looker.
And the copycat is someone who knows that all of the victims were strangled to death.
It's you.
Because he was the first witness in each case, the person capable of replicating the mailman's crimes is...
The Worshipper! You're the copycat criminal!
Domino dancey dance. Domino dancey dance. Alright. That, it has been done.
This is the truth of the case!
Give me your soul! We have been reaped. It's over for you.
What's that?
Their souls.
It's the truth.
Oh, after
the soul of the true culprit who built this mystery labyrinth.
You gotta first
see.
Wait, what
it
happened?
Looks otherworldly, but there's an ominous air around it.
This far, thanks to you.
Oh, the souls. Oh, okay.
I only kept my part of the deal. You made the right choice hiring me.
Oh, Alara.
But I will say one thing. You've taken another step toward being a detective.
Oh.
That much is certain. I, Alara Nightmare, acknowledge you.
Really, Alara? You... do?
The handshake. Ma'am, that was just a tender moment, and then here you come.
All right, all eyes on Shinigami.
What's about to happen?
Here we go.
Isn't it obvious? It's the moment we've all been waiting for. Time to boot kill the bad guy.
They really do just be floating there. I love the music for this
too. Bloodlust.
At least the beginning part.
Shall expunge this cursed case!
Actually, no, I just love the whole song now. I wish they also put the song in the sound first. Like, they put some really good bangers on there, but they only put 10. Like, I would have loved a 4. Just wanna see, you know? It's giving panty and stalking at the end of, like, beating the demon for that day, or the goose for that day type of vibe. That's what it's giving. Oh, gosh. Detective Deeds. Amaterasu Corporation. Oh, Montu. A popular meat, but oh, I already read that one. All right, you guys. Master Detective 2009. Read that one before. Well, Detective Organization. Seth's Creed. The Burroughs family motto is silence is golden. To this day, Seth mumbles in adherence to that creed. Well, that's why he doesn't speak loud. TV programs. Nearly all the TV programs broadcasted in Kanai Ward are sponsored by Amaterasu Corporation. Alright. Time to give the verdict. And they're dead!
Father?
Are you alright?
Why he run over like that? He's just like, dee-dee.
What's going on? What happened to those two?
They're dead, sir.
There's the pulse. They're dead!
Dead? What?
What? What is this?
Oh shoot, even Hilara's like a little like, yo, what the?
I sure worked hard today.
Wait, why is Hilara? Wait, what? Wait, did we actually explicitly tell? I don't think they actually explicitly told them.
The mystery labyrinth crumbles when you reap the soul of the true culprit. Then, the cause of the mystery labyrinth's creation pays the price by vanishing with it. I knew this would happen, but it still hurts to see someone die before my eyes. It's like I killed them myself.
Don't think like that. Think about it that way.
I did kill them. I killed them with the ruthless blade of the truth.
Truth is a tough pill to swallow.
There. Humans boom kill cows and pigs all the time and eat them. You don't feel bad about that, right? These were the souls of deranged murderers. At least you didn't eat them. If you look at it that way, there's nothing to feel bad about at all.
It's not so simple when it comes to people dying.
Did you people do this? Did you kill them with some kind of poison?
You're next, okay, no.
Hey, hold on. I have no idea what's going on here. Too much is happening all at once.
The poor man, he's so confused. He doesn't deserve this.
We shall talk at headquarters. Follow me there.
No.
Is it just me, or are things more complicated now than before?
That's my thing too. Like, once they're dead, it's just like, you can't really ensure the true culprit's dead, but how does that, you know? I don't know.
Oh, you want help? Are you going to rely on me again? Fine. I can't say no when you ask for help.
I didn't even really truly ask, but I mean, pop off, I guess, queen. Go ahead and do what you're trying to do.
Everyone!
Wait!
He came back alive!
Oh god!
Sorry about that. You see, I'm actually the mailman.
What?
These are my final words, so I can't lie.
I'm the mailman.
There is just a copycat criminal. Search the church for the tools used in each crime. I'm sure you'll find plenty of evidence.
Bro, I'm crying.
If you think I'm lying, go ahead and check it out. Thanks!
Thanks, like, you know. The priest seemed gone.
I didn't know you could do that. But that was a super lazy confession. Will it work?
It should.
It should do it. We even have witnesses, so this case is closed.
The
priest mumbled something, but couldn't quite hear him.
You a whole lie.
Anyway, everyone here will be taken to Amaterasu Corporation at once.
What?
It wasn't effective at all.
He's so stubborn. This is why I hate authority.
What do we do?
Wait. I hear something.
And what is that?
Huh? What now?
A motorbike. Something is heading this way at an alarming speed.
What the heck is going on now?
It can't be.
Seth knows what's up. What's up, Seth? What's going on? Why are you afraid, Seth?
Where is that coming from?
What the? Excuse me?
No. What are you doing here?
Come back.
Oh god!
Oh.
Who are you?
Come back to life. We come back with the dead to confess
you to. Dare speak so carelessly? Who do you think I am?
The hero who defends peace and order in Kanai Ward. Director of the Amaterasu Peacekeepers.
Hello, sailor. We must stay focused. We must stay focused.
Peacekeeper's director?
Yeah, that wasn't a Kira reference. You're right. You're right. I just... He's a bad guy. He's a bad guy.
So he is the head of the Peacekeepers.
He's a bad guy.
Now you know, small fry. Bow down.
Sir. Anyway.
What are you doing here?
No need to be alarmed.
She's also kind of pretty.
Benevolent Director Yomi is here to help.
Why'd you say it like that?
Oh,
also, why you?
Excuse
the ball
me for the late introduction. I am Vice Director of the Peacekeepers, Martina.
Why the bonk? What'd I do? She's kind of pretty.
She's my beloved right hand.
Okay, I don't know
no
how to feel about that. Why are you creeping like that? Why are you... I don't know what you're talking about. I didn't do anything. But sir, why...
What's with him?
Master.
See, Spieler gets
be
it.
Be careful. This Yomi guy is dangerous.
See, when you see stuff like that, it just... Shitty.
What brings you here?
Yako, just back down. Don't even say nothing, Yako. Just back down.
Oh, right. I was so focused on my beloved right hand that I completely forgot.
Can I just take her place? I mean, anyway.
As mentioned earlier, Director Yomi is here to help.
Always here to help?
I hear you've been troubled by Seth's unreasonable treatment.
Oh, he's finally back up.
Right?
Huh?
Director Yomi, what is going on here?
Oh, that's what I'm saying. I mean, she's pretty. She's pretty as well. I mean, you know. I'm just saying.
Why am I?
Oh, he's so. Now I kind of feel a little bad for him. I mean, he is just following directives.
We
you know?
Have discovered you've been receiving sizable kickbacks for facilitating donations meant for the church.
Excuse me?
We now know why you were so desperate to clean up all the nailman killings. After all, it would be troublesome to lose access to all that money if the priest was arrested as the nailman.
Wait, please. Director Yomi, I did this under your orders.
Oh, man, it'd be funny if they just stole the microphone from him.
Did you say something? Because I didn't hear it.
That face. Anyway. Poka, you called it.
I only did this because you ordered me to.
Now I feel a little bad for him, just a tiny bit, not really, but just a little bit. You know?
Seth, you make me sad. I'm the hero and defender of peace in this city. My peacekeepers are proud soldiers of that mission,
and yet. You let yourself be corrupted.
Not the crying, anyway.
Good, Seth. For the sake of the peacekeepers and the peace of Kanai Ward,
die.
Oh shit!
Taking advantage of your position as a peacekeeper executive is a serious crime. The punishment must be severe.
Anyway. Are they gonna kill him? Like, no, I don't want him to die, though. Not per se. Oh, no. Oh,
yeah, I'm annoyed my own underling would betray me like this. I'm so annoyed, I'd go insane if I didn't toy around with my beloved right hand.
What do you mean by that? You know, when... when human beings were created, you got a right hand and a left hand. Do you need a left hand? I'm just anyway.
It's an honor.
What is going on? But what? Okay, I'm not gonna.
He's terrible. Like a lizard cutting off its own tail to survive.
Not even gonna.
Someone like him is in charge.
Like,
of the
whoa.
Don't look him in the eyes. Don't talk to him either.
Don't look.
If possible, don't even breathe the same air.
Those people do it. I mean, you think?
Well then. To our shit for brains friends playing detective. Looks like I have to give you a warning.
See, if I keep messing around, though, I can run the chance of running into you again, so I'm gonna just keep doing what I'm doing.
Know your place in my city and stay there. Follow the rules and don't disturb our peace. Or I'll need you to...
Oh, I didn't mean to cut him off! No, can I go back? Can I go back? I didn't mean to cut him off! That face, though. Anyway,
In this city, Director Yomi is both the law and the peacekeepers itself.
Mm-hmm.
Defying us means you defy law and order. You will receive fitting treatment for such behavior.
I mean, he is the head of them all, so I mean...
Before, you were insignificant specks of dust. But now that you've banded together, you've become an eyesore. Detectives, my ass. Annoying little shits.
Am I like, Sephiroth? Hello? Did he just spit on him?
That's not very nice.
Did he just spit on him? What? Okay. Alright, that's what we do. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Let's go, my beloved right hand.
Wow.
Yes, Director Yomi.
Well then. He just spit on him. Captain Obvious is
looks like we've been targeted by someone dangerous.
That Yubi guy. I got a bad feeling. I mean, look, it's okay.
Yeah, thanks to you! One wrong move and it would have been all over. You got that?
I'm sorry, but...
No buts! None! How did this happen anyway?
Gosh darn it.
Alara, help me out. Please explain what happened.
I mean, you both need to let him... Let him spit on him to survive. I mean, yeah, I guess.
You said you acknowledged me as a detective, didn't you?
What? When did I say that?
Oh, don't tell me.
Huh?
It's such a shame, Master. Everything that happens in the Mystery Labyrinth gets forgotten.
Oh, that's cruel. That's cruelty.
What?
Alara's memory must have been wiped after entering and leaving the Labyrinth. Nothing inside the Mystery Labyrinth can be taken into the real world. Not even memories.
That's foul.
Unless you have a contract with yours truly, that is.
But...
Labyrinth are retained, like the debt you owe for your assignment.
That's awful!
Oh my god.
Hey, Yuma? Are you listening? You better make sure this doesn't happen again.
By the way, Chief, our submarine office is tipping over. Are you sure the peacekeepers didn't mess with it?
Oh gosh.
What? Seriously? I have to go back and repair it! Yuma, help me out! Follow me!
Oh, Yako. This poor
man.
It
was supposed to be time for you to reveal the solution. But we've ended up in quite the mess. Huh?
Yeah.
This is my first time dealing with the true culprit dying.
It's gonna happen a
accused.
Lot more. Did we still have that understanding? I swear, all his huhs and hums are so much louder than any other voice line he does.
Alara.
Look, the chief is calling for you. You should go.
Right. Thank you.
The wink. Oh. Freaking precious Alara. about Master Detectives, WDO, Dragon Place. No, I think I've read about that too. Yeah, no, I read about that. Amaterasu Corporation. It be soon that Yuma will soon be an outcast of the city, that every time he solves a mystery, he will be the new mystery on a string of murders. Oh my god. I mean, fair enough. Oh my gosh, it's... I totally didn't cheat and take a bunch of, like, pictures of...
Are you serious?
It's okay.
A peacekeeper executive was taking bribes from the church?
If Director Yomi said so, it would be considered the truth, even if it isn't.
Mm-hmm. What about the priest?
Publicly announced as the truth. Mm-hmm. It appears the priest's strong desire to save others turned him into the nail man.
He
saw people wishing for revenge as they hammered those nails in the forest, and decided he needed to save them. That was the motive, though it could all be a story made up by the peacekeepers.
So, what about the kitty cat criminal?
Oh yeah, her name, the kitty cat. Get out, Fubuki. Just get out.
You mean the copycat?
That one was already publicized as well. They say the copycat did it out of admiration.
And he felt so much guilt that he poisoned himself? None of this really makes any sense.
That sure didn't look like death by poison to me.
It just dropped.
It's me! I did it along with that detective kneeling in penitence over there.
It would make more sense to assume Yomi killed them somehow. Especially when you consider the timing. He'd do it without batting an eye.
Yeah, but it wasn't.
Yomi Hellsmile, the director of the Peacekeepers.
I heard he rode in on a dragon.
Fubuki, again, get out.
No, it was a motorcycle.
From what I've investigated, the Peacekeeper's influence is gaining ground at Amaterasu Corporation. And there's some sort of power struggle going on. Seems like they're getting their way internally. I hear that their boss, Yomi, is extraordinarily dangerous.
Extraordinary.
Anyway,
so he is very normal?
Why did she break it up like
this? Scary.
How are you a detective in an... How did you make it this far? How are you alive?
It's only a matter of time until the Peacekeepers gain complete control of the corporation. When that happens, they might outright attack the World Detective Organization.
No. Fubuki is gonna give me headaches.
Perhaps
and to think
WDO
at some point I'm gonna have to work
because
with her.
They saw the warning sign.
Gosh.
If that's the case, it could have something to do with Kanai Ward's ultimate secret.
Oh yeah, what's the deal with Kanai Ward's ultimate secret? We still know nothing about it, huh?
He's an airhead, but I give her no. So my thing is, how did she? If she's this, like, she didn't even know that chocolate doesn't grow on trees, already pre-wrapped in the foil in a dewdrop, like a Hershey's Kiss. Like, come on.
It doesn't seem to have anything to do with the nailman incident. I wonder what it could be. Sheesh, so much to deal with. This sounds exhausting.
Didn't I tell you that from the start? Well, we got some very talented master detectives gathered here. I'm sure it'll be fine.
Oh, now he's trying to be positive again.
Yeah.
So
much. No, everything changes from now on. Yuma, you can take a seat now.
My legs feel numb.
Oh, I'm a little shake.
Don't stick your neck out recklessly from now on, for everyone's sake. Got it?
Got it.
Hey, we worked super hard. I'm so stressed, I could die. Oh, wait, but I can't die.
Alright, now what do?
Do we have a visitor? That's rare. Yuma, can you go get it?
Wow, okay.
Sure.
There he goes, just following orders again. But before I go to do that, hello.
Mm-hmm.
How kind of you. I didn't think you'd come check, because I want to, you beautiful bean. But she'd probably go check the visitor instead. They might go
yes.
Check him out and get home. Okay, I'll go do it. It's a little boy.
Oh, it's you.
My dad is back safe at home. It's all thanks to you. Thank you for helping us.
It makes it worth it.
No, I just... Well, I'm happy for you.
Aw, look at you getting thanked. You were on your knees just a moment ago.
Talk about it.
Be quiet.
Oh! There's one more thing I want to ask.
Did someone else die or something?
Will you play catch with me?
Oh, my heart. Of course I'll play catch with you, you sweet
baby. Huh? Catch? But it's raining.
It's always
actually
raining.
Sure. Let's play.
Why not? Makes it worth it. Makes it so worth it.
The unending rain. My memories still seem like faraway raindrops. My hands still have yet to grasp a single thing. I am still lost. Is it all right for me to be here? But with the worn baseball gripped in my hand, my heart somehow feels lighter. Why I wanted to be a detective, it could have been for the sake of something so small that it fits in my hand.
Yeah, I got a pretty good throw, actually. Both
Maybe
of them.
Maybe I should give myself credit for this small realization.
Please.
So, for just a bit longer, I think I'll keep pretending to be a detective.
You know, people will assume Yuma's a serial killer because of the time he has to remake how they feel like we hated it. I mean, but nope, they don't get to see him do that in the labyrinth, so... And that was only with that case, you know? Maybe in the future case, he might have to also do it. I don't know. Alright, let's see. SS on destruction. SS on judgment. SS on that. SS on stamina. Let's go! Let's go! And I ranked up. Nice. Next. So we're going to save. This is the material, so we're saving this. I'm gonna do, tutorials on how to go through the mystery labyrinths and such, so. I'm just saving at the beginning of each one, or creating a save file at the beginning for each one. I can just easily go back to it. And do it like that. So that's happening. So with that, we should be bringing the stream into a close. Can I? Okay, I have to wait till this goes over. So I can go into like chapter two. Chapter one, chapter two. I think this is chapter two.
Unpainted faces in uniform by the window.
Okay.
This isn't the real me. With that, a hand reaches out and misses the stars, grazing off dusk.
Okay.
In the shadow of the school after class lies the remnants of everything someone has lost.
Okay. All right. So who knows, though, Yuma ever gets the time to explain his forte, people think he's crazy no matter what. So Yuma can't explain it, or if for some reason he'll die. Apparently that's what Shinigami says, or something like that, or whatever, and the pack will be broken. So, yeah. Man, he's booked. Bro, who was tailing him? We get away from- what type of- where are you- bro, are you good? Yako, what's going on, buddy? Why you running? What's going on? Okay, so we're gonna save one more time. Save. Oh, I cannot save now. Well, this is going to be the end of the stream regardless anyway. I wanna thank everyone that came. I hope you guys had a lovely, wonderful time. Scuff, why you got stuck? but when it's me, I'm kidding. Anyway, hopefully no one heard that. In this dream, I'm gonna finally eat dinner. It is 1 a.m. So that's pretty fun. But yeah, I hope everyone has a lovely afternoon, evening, morning, night, whatever conception of time may be for you. And I'm gonna bounce out.